It's been a busy day.
It's been a busy week. It's been a busy month. It's always busy. Well, what's new?
It's always busy. It's Thursday night, and normally we're here on Tuesday nights. Tonight, we're here on Thursday. We had some issues with Ustream.
Oh, the old guy's Parnelli. I know that name.
Okay. Yeah. Calls him the old guy again. After we went off the air on Tuesday night.
Oh, I was thinking about that. That'd be like,
here.
That'd be like if he was in the chat saying, yeah, I met the two WZR hosts, but he forgot our names and had to say, like, the one in the hat was a nice guy, but the fat one was rude. I would know damn well I'm the fat one. He's old.
Minute.
What do you mean do? You had a couple birthdays. That doesn't mean you're not a good dude.
Parnelli.
He was cool as shit.
Parnelli in the chat, he was an awesome guy. He was
very
awesome.
Nice.
Everybody that we met. At NXT on Saturday night. Couldn't have been nicer.
Very nice.
Awesome. Parnelli, if you don't mind us asking your age, let us know in the chat, but I would say
60-something?
45, 55.
Oh, wow.
Between 45 and 55 is
you know
what Parnelli
let me change that. Probably low 50s is what I would say.
I would say low 50s.
Or high 40s with a large drug past.
45 to 55.
All right.
45 to 55.
He had some wear and tear going on.
Somewhere in there. But,
yeah.
But when
which,
I look at myself.
Which will happen when we get up there. You know.
When I look at myself, I'm 34. I'll be 35.
I forget my number,
too. I forget my age.
I don't know if I'm turning 31 or 32 in July, but yeah.
So I'm gonna be
31.
I'm gonna be 35. So he's only what 10 years older than I am, or 15 years older.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not that far off from that. So anyway, but everybody
55. I knew it.
55. Okay. All right.
If it was Price is Right, I would have got it because I didn't go over and I was closest.
But I said 45.
I said early 50s.
Yeah, but I said 45. Yeah, you're right.
You can't take up 10 numbers all in one guess, man.
So listen, so we're here on Thursday night. We had Ustream issues on Tuesday. We made the decision to cancel on Tuesday. And when I did that, everybody went on Facebook and they said, you know damn well, come Thursday night, they're not going to be here. They forgot about it.
Yeah.
Or it's Thursday night, something
and if he would
awesome. They're not going
to
be here.
We wouldn't have been here tonight, so... You could thank this guy for a show.
I
was dropping hints all day, like, come on, man.
So I had said, I know it's Thursday. It feels weird. It just feels...
It's like when we did that WrestleMania thing, that one, like, it's still sunny, like, I don't know why, but usually when it's 8 o'clock on a Tuesday, it's dark outside. I don't know why
well,
it's
we different. Well, we had the time change, and then it's summertime, so the sun sets.
But it just feels weird, yeah. Like, it's not Tuesday, it's not 8, there's no SmackDown taping going on right
it's
now.
It's weird. It's definitely weird.
Yeah, but SmackDown's actually airing against us right now.
So I promised the people that on Thursday night we would be here, and I said, we got to do a show on Thursday, no matter what, come hell or high water, we're doing a show. And here we are. So,
well, it was bad, too, because when we went to Raw, we never did a show that week.
I know.
Or the week after that. I believe we took 2 weeks
and
off.
And then we went to NXT, so
and we missed
would be...
the show right after NXT, so we had to do the makeup show this time.
Well, plus, not only that, but you had Payback on Sunday.
Yeah.
Do we have... We don't have the reports.
Yeah, I got NXT, Payback,
man, look
Raw.
At you. Look at you.
I already told him this.
So we had that.
Obviously wasn't listening.
I never listened to you. Yeah. Never listened
to you. Funny, because he asked the question, did you open up the chat room? And I said,
would
yeah,
you
I got,
listen, would you
I got
listen
the chat,
to
I got Raw. I told him every... Just 2 seconds ago.
Would you listen to this guy?
It
a guy
is.
Like this? Would you listen? Anyway, Brian Medalla, Mandy. What's up, brother?
Who the
What's up,
hell?
Sister? They're my buddies.
Is that the background
over here in Menance?
Oh, no.
They're listening live tonight. Got to give them a shout-out. Send them the link right before. So, Brian and Mandy.
Oh, I know Brian.
What up, what up?
I know who he is because you talk about him,
Yeah, he's a good guy, man. He's just here about an hour ago.
Well, I thought you were talking about the backyard wrestler guy. What was that guy that we met? What was his name?
The guy from Montreal?
Yeah, the Canadian guy. And his girlfriend.
I'm not sure.
Okay.
I don't know.
I thought you said you've seen clips of him and everything and...
Yeah, no, there was they've got a thing on YouTube where they do like backyard wrestling stuff.
He beat her up.
He whooped her ass, and she took a pretty good pretty good beat
too.
Girls
are tough.
Yeah.
Hey man, so they like squeeze a fucking 9-pound human right out of a lawn.
Out of a what? Out of a what?
Out of
he says they could squeeze a 9-pound human right out of a.
You could do the Larry David, you know, you go like the big pussy girls. And,
anyway,
he said, Larry David says, "Oh man, and men are so much more discreet than women. Women love doing this. They love this thing." He says, "Well, I'll tell you something else. This is me from now on, buddy. This is me from now on." He said, "Think about it biologically. Shouldn't there be as many big vaginas as there are all small penises?"
Hey, speaking of Larry David,
yeah.
And it's kind of an odd transition, but Larry David has been on the David Letterman show and many times. And
a couple times.
And David Letterman finished up last night,
man.
That was it for Letterman. So he's done, man. I'm gonna miss. And Stephen Colbert. What do you think?
We never watched Letterman. He watches Kimmel.
I watch Kimmel. Yeah. But Jimmy Kimmel favored my tweets the other day.
Yeah.
Favored it. By the way,
four of them.
Speaking of Twitter, we're going
7 million followers
all over the place.
Yeah.
Listen. So I start getting. Did I show you? I think I showed him on Tuesday night, but
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
I got
about right
a brand new iPhone 6
the thumbprint and all that.
Right? I love it. I freaking love it, man. I've never been big on Apple, you know, but this Apple.
That's an iPhone?
This is the brand new iPhone.
Okay.
iPhone 6.
How much was that thing?
Like $500.
That's disgusting. That is gross.
500.
I paid like $150 for mine. It was the Android.
I freaking love this thing. It's so cool. You see it? And it's awesome.
I didn't do anything with it though. So it was a total waste of money. I just texted people and took pictures.
Yeah, it's excellent. I love it.
I spent like hundreds of dollars on it.
So I go on Twitter, right, and I start getting text messages and this stuff is coming in on Twitter, right? And it's Tammy Sitch. Sunny, right?
Yeah.
And she says, I hear you got a problem with me. I hear you're talking shit about me. What's the
probably
deal?
The porn thing.
What's the deal? I thought we were cool.
Because you seen she came out and spoke out against the porn thing today, saying it's bullshit, basically.
It's not. There's two things we're going to address.
So clearly true.
The Tammy Sitch, Vivid, that whole thing. Yeah. And then TNA Impact. All right, listen, there were reports last night that came out. We have, big exclusive update for you guys, which is going to come here in about 15 or 20 minutes. So stay tuned. We're going to wait for most of the people to come in, but we've got a big update.
After talking with multiple people in the industry, you've got
today. I haven't. I
can vouch for that this time. I actually saw some of the shit you.
Right. Yeah. Right. I didn't even get time to put it up on the website, so I put it up on Facebook. I said, if you tune in tonight, give it to you here first, and then when we go off the air, there's going to be a report that goes online that I'll put up on the website.
And you should always
mention
articles like that.
We're going to
give
it to you guys here first tonight.
You should always mention articles like that. We broke it first on the radio. That way, more people want to listen to the radio. You know.
Well, and that's part of that. I mean, I really didn't have the time. You know how busy I was. I didn't come in here.
I mean, after you break it on the radio and then you write the article, you should always mention in the article, this isn't the first time you would be hearing about this if you listen to the show, you know, in a professional worded way.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So we're gonna let you guys, has Destination America, have they canceled TNA Impact Wrestling? What's the deal? Is the story true? Story not true? Are there certain parts of the story that are true and some are not true? So, about 15 or 20 minutes from now, we're going to give you guys that. And normally, we're here every Tuesday night from 8 to 10 Eastern Time. I know a lot of people are tuned in tonight just to hear what's up with Impact Wrestling. So, we're going to give that to you here in just a couple of minutes. So, I go on Twitter, right? And Tammy is, you know, what's the deal? I thought we were cool, blah, 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 blah. I said, I have a problem with you. What are you talking about? And she says, somebody's been telling me you've been talking shit. And there's always that one guy, I put it up on Facebook today, there's always that one guy that wants to, like, that doesn't like me.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot of people that don't like me for some reason. I think I'm a nice guy.
I would be flattered if, I somebody cared enough, thought enough about me to try and spread a rumor to another famous person. Not that I'm famous,
weird,
but to another
weird.
A famous person about me. Like, well, how did that even come into their head? Like,
it's just weird.
Yeah.
So anyway.
Well, I mean, we got a glimpse of that at NXT. Like, whether you like it or not, there's a lot of fucking people watching right now.
Well, I had, like, guys on the comments section, right, where I put the notice up that, hey, listen, we're going to be at NXT. If you want to meet up. If you want to meet up, we'll meet up, and I will buy you a beer, right? That's what I put up on the website. And I get people on the comments section saying, if I was in Albany, I'd punch you right in the face.
Oh, they're going to say something like, oh, you'll buy a beer. You couldn't buy him a mixed drink?
Yeah.
Motherfucker, you couldn't buy him a mixed drink?
Just people like, now's your chance, folks, to go up and punch Ryan Clark in the mouth, or now's your chance to beat his ass. If I ever met you, I'd slap you right in the mouth, or something like that. I'm trying to buy you a beer. Trying to buy you, keyboard warrior.
No,
is that what they call?
Scared is what that is right there. The Scott Hall move.
Yeah. But anyway, So, this is what we're going to do. We are going to, first of all, we're going to talk about NXT for Saturday night. Then we're going to get into Payback. Then we're going to get into Raw. Then we're going to get into the NXT TakeOver special from last night, which is a very good show.
Samoa Joe
wound up debuting. A lot of backstage news that we just put up on the websites over the last couple of hours. The return of WWE Tough Enough. Daniel Bryan's WWE future in jeopardy.
Sami Zayn surgery.
Steve Austin's Sami Zayn surgery. Hideo Itami. Yeah. Sonny Porn stuff. There's a lot that we need to
and
talk about.
There's a lot too, but we never talk about any of that shit. So.
Yeah, yeah. So anyway, all right. Let's get these plugs out of the way. Then we'll get into it. We'll start with NXT in Albany from this past Saturday.
Well, you should address this real quick. Martinelli did say, "I didn't get my beer, even though I don't drink." What the fuck? And he's clearly joking.
Right.
But there was a reason we couldn't buy people beers that night.
Right.
They weren't selling them.
They didn't sell.
They weren't selling alcohol. And a wrestling and show with thousands of people.
And we'll tell you why. We'll tell you why
in
just a quick second. But anyway, the official home, the official website of WZR TV, Tuesdays, normally on Tuesday, yeah. WZRonline.com. We are on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube as well. Go to Facebook.com/WZRArmy, YouTube.com/WZRArchive. We're on Twitter as well. All you got to do is go to WZRonline.com. Top navigation bar. It's got a social media tab. Drop-down menu. It's got all the links to Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. WZRonline.com, the official home of WZR TV Tuesdays.
There you go.
NXT, Saturday night, Albany, New York.
Yes.
And
before we get into any of it, I do want to say thank you to my boss, Michael Schalick. He bought me some tickets that you and Ryan go to the show and have a good time.
Right.
If you remember, when we were doing the show, not Tuesday, last week, he was bugging the fuck out of me during the show, and I kept saying stuff like, "He knows I'm doing a show right now. Why is he buying?"
Yeah.
That was why.
He was in the middle
of buying them.
He did buy them on that Tuesday night. Yeah.
So that was why. But anyway,
so,
thank you.
So, thank you big time.
Greg, one of the best shows I've ever been to.
So, before the show began,
we
were pre-gaming here. We drank a lot of beer.
Yeah.
I drank a lot of beer.
And I did during the day. I got sick, too, so I didn't fully enjoy it. Parnelli's talking about it now.
We drink a lot of beer, right?
Yeah.
And we get there, and I gave out a work phone number that people could contact us. And you all know, the people that have been watching for years and years now, Boone has always made fun of me and said, "You really meet up with people? You really buy people beers?"
He said.
Before we went to the event on Saturday, you said, "I say maybe 3-4 people are going to come up to us."
Well, he kept trying to prepare me, like, you don't understand.
People are going to come up.
It's going to be insane how many people recognize us. And I said, "I don't think you understand. Maybe 3 or 4 people will notice us throughout the whole evening." And as we were walking to the car after the show, I had no problem telling you right to your face. I said, "You know what? I was wrong, and you were big time right, because that was insane."
So we go into the arena, and
this is like being a celebrity.
We start
on a movie set or something. Like, everybody's like, "Oh, hey!" Like they, like you. I was telling you, like, people that you've never met or seen before are looking you dead in the eyes,
saying, "Is that him?"
It's weird because they're not saying nothing yet, but they're staring right in your fucking eyes. And thank God I wasn't belligerent drunk, because I probably would have hit somebody. Like, what the fuck are you looking at? You know, I get like that at bars sometimes. Like, what the fuck are you looking at?
Right.
Insecure shit. You're drunk and insecure shit. But, yeah, every time somebody would glare at me, I'm like, oh, they must recognize. Because we're wearing the shirts and everything, you know.
Well, that's the thing. We wear the WZR t-shirts, and people recognize the shirt and whatnot. So, we get into the arena, and listen,
they take your shirts from
the arena. I had a bunch of t-shirts that I was going to give to people, and they wouldn't allow me in the arena with a backpack. So, kind of had to wait after the show. I told everybody, "Listen, I'll be outside after the show if you want to come up. I've got a backpack that I'm going to get back after the show and give you guys t-shirts." And we got a lot of t-shirts out after the show. Some of the people that came outside, they met up with us.
We waited there for like 20 minutes, and still somehow we missed somebody that was calling us out.
We missed a bunch of people, to be honest with you.
Yeah, a couple people.
But
wanted to go to Bombers.
Yeah. So we were able to get some t-shirts out after the show, but we went in there, and listen, the arena holds a capacity of 4,300 people, right? The Washington Avenue Armory. I know you and I kind of disagree on the attendance, but there were easily, if the arena holds 4,300 people,
which is what it says when you Google it,
almost all of the bleachers were sold out. I mean, there was a very select few seats. The entire
and most
floor,
of those were people like us standing up and walking around the whole time.
The
like
entire
if we
floor,
had like we weren't celebrities to the management or the building security, but for some reason we had carte blanche to just go in. We were walking all over the earth, right at the fucking ring, talking to Sam Roberts and running around, and you know, anywhere we wanted to go, we hit every corner of that arena.
Ryan says when Ryan gave me the WZR T-shirt at the ROH show, people thought that I would. Rygal, I'm sitting there with Rygal at Ring of Honor in New York City, right? And I think Rygal's on the right-hand side of me, and he just like this. I'm Rygal, and you're me.
Yeah.
And Rygal comes over and he goes, yo, look right here, yeah. Look right here. And I look up to the guy in front of me, okay. Right? And he's on his telephone. And he's got WCRonline.com up on the telephone. I said, don't say anything.
Don't make a big... Yeah.
But he's looking at WCR Online in the seat in front of us.
Did he do a double take? Like,
WCR?
What the fuck?
I don't think he turned around. I don't know.
The guy right there!
Pretty drunk. Yeah. But anyway, so NXT, we had a great time. First of all, I waited for about 10 minutes in the beer line or the concession line.
Yeah.
I get there and I said, "What kind of beer do you have?" And the guy says, "No, we don't sell beer." There was a big fight. Migos, who is a rapper, drew a lot of people in the Armory. They had a big brawl. It made national media attention.
How long ago was this?
Probably about 3 or 4 months ago.
Yeah,
but
this was recent.
TMZ, Huffington Post, all these websites started. You know, they had video, and it was a massive brawl that broke out at the Armory.
Yeah.
So the state, the legislators in the state threatened to shut the venue down. They stripped them of their liquor license. They said you've got to hire extra security if you want to run events. They complied with everything. Liquor license gone. Extra security hired. So, for the meet, what happened?
I don't know.
What happened? Well, are we off?
This happened the other week, too. Remember?
Really?
Yeah.
So we don't have, is it going to reboot?
It did last. You just turned it better.
Oh, okay. All right. But anyway, so they say, you know, there's no beer, right? And of course...
Enter on that keyboard back there. Or wait 30 seconds.
One off again? Really? So we're not going to have a chat? Can we load the stuff up on there? Will I talk? Will you do that? I'm sorry. But anyway... It's a live radio show. What are you going to do? So anyway, so we got pretty drunk before we went, but then there was no beer being sold in the arena. So
isn't that the worst?
I gotta start
drinking early.
I know.
And you're already
no
drunk,
beer.
And then you go somewhere, and you can't get alcohol, and you're like, what the fuck, man? I got to just slowly fade down.
And it was the one guy screaming the entire time, where's the beer? Get the beer. We want beer. Everybody, we even saw Kellen. Kellen was there too, man.
He's like, hold on, I gotta go get a beer.
no beer, man. But, so anyway, that crowd, I've been to Ring of Honor shows, I've been to WWE shows, I've been to a lot of wrestling events, man.
Yeah.
And Ring of Honor comes pretty goddamn close. Some of the New York City, one or two of the New York City shows that I've been to, they were really good. But NXT, that crowd was so freaking loud on Saturday night, man. That crowd was awesome from top to bottom. They knew everything. I would say there were easily over 3,000 fans in that building. I called the Armory today and got a voicemail, but I called around 5 o'clock, so I was thinking maybe they had shut down. Normally it's like an 8 to 5 type thing. But I'm trying to get an official attendance for the NXT show at the Armory. So I'm going to try to call them again tomorrow and see what I can get. But I would say if the arena holds a capacity of 4,300, there were easily over 3,000 people in there, as everything was filled except for the aisleways that you've got to go and the concession stand and that area where you could fit a couple more hundred people. If they had chairs in
if they filled every spot that was available, you could have fit another six, seven, 800.
I'd say six, seven, 800, somewhere around there. But capacity 4,300. You got to figure in the walkways and everything else. So I would say there was a good 3,200 people there, which is pretty freaking crazy. We beat out Philly. Some of the, even the talent put on Twitter that the Albany crowd was better than Philly, and that's a tough feat.
Sam Roberts said that. Yeah, he was at both.
We met Sam Roberts.
The kid in Montreal that we met was at both. He said it just as louder tonight.
Yeah, so Albany represented, man. It was a great show.
Shocking, I was telling Shock last night, it was almost an agreement beforehand, like, as everybody was walking through the door, it was almost like somebody pulled every single person aside as they're coming in and said,
Leave
your ego here.
Right, right.
And just go have fun. And everybody was down to have fun. Like you said, the first match, we cover wrestling for a living. We didn't even know who the fuck one of these guys was.
Well, they were chanting.
And they're chanting the guy's thing, and we're like, what are they saying? We don't even know it.
Still don't even know the chant. It's,
SWAFT.
SWAFT. Yeah. Something like that. SWAFT.
Yeah. And they're like, you look stupid. Like, and they all knew to do it. Like, and I'm like, I don't watch NXT every week. I watch specials.
Sasha Banks, they're chanting, you are ratchet. No, she
wretched.
Isn't.
Yeah, wretched.
Wretched.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You are wretched. No, she isn't. You are wretched.
You look good in person.
Charlotte and,
she didn't look so good, but yeah.
Well, before the Divas match between Charlotte and Sasha Banks even started, before the bell even rang, this is awesome. This is awesome, Chance. And I think, Charlotte and Sasha Banks was probably the second best match on. Sasha and,
Professionalism.
Yeah.
How loud it probably was.
Yeah, I know. Sorry about that. Sasha and,
it was, Charlotte. And Charlotte, yeah.
Probably had the second best match on the show.
And I didn't see the special last night, but from what I hear, you could argue Sasha's match was like the second best on that show too.
Yeah, it was. It really was.
Everybody thought it was Charlotte carrying her when they were having their matches before Sasha won the title.
Right.
And now people are like, oh no, Sasha's just a fucking little gangster broad. Like,
she was awesome.
Awesome.
She was awesome.
Yeah,
so
she gets marketing, like all the she'll take stuff from like pop culture and make it her phrases.
So
and
we have Tyler Breeze come out, right? And Tyler comes out first for the main event, right?
Yeah.
And then it's time for Finn Balor to come out. The entrance that everybody wants to see.
What is going on here? What is it? Is it your leg under there?
No. Sorry. High quality production here.
Yeah, very professional.
But, so the main event, so we're there to see Finn Balor in his entrance, right?
Yeah.
And Tyler Breeze, and they're stalling and stalling and stalling and stalling. And this goes on for like a good 4 minutes, 3 minutes?
Just about. Maybe,
somewhere in
maybe
that?
Yeah, 4 or 5 minutes.
Tyler Breeze is doing his, where he gets on the ring ropes, right? And he's kind of posing, and he's taking selfies. And clearly something is not right. So eventually, they're not going to get this thing fixed, right? Finn Balor comes to the ring, and comes out, gets a huge pop, with no entrance, no nothing.
Yeah.
Comes down and does the whoa, and the whole crowd went along with it.
Yeah.
Whoa! And then as soon as he hits the ring,
when he gets up in the corner and does that thing on the middle rope on the outside, he's like hanging over the top.
Yeah.
And then he did the big one, and then, the music came on for that part.
The music hits, man.
Finally.
And then
Owens came out, music worked just fine. So the only entrance that was affected by this was Balor. So that wasn't
Balor.
The only audio glitch of the night. They were having, who was it, Ethan announcing?
JoJo.
JoJo announcing. She couldn't talk, like she was talking, nobody could hear her at one point.
Right.
So there was other glitches, but the only entrance glitch was the entrance.
Like, the one
that everybody probably bought a ticket to see. That was going to be my highlight of the night, to see that cool shit in person.
So, and then here's the other thing. Is I've been telling you for years now, Kevin Steen is the fucking man, bro.
Yeah.
Kevin Steen is awesome, man. You, coming out of the event, said, you know what, dude? Kevin Steen is pretty fucking good.
He's an entertaining dude, man.
He was
like
awesome.
Scary, talented. Like, but the stuff. See, this is where I got to take umbrage, because the only thing I'd ever. I didn't watch Ring of Honor, I don't watch anything.
You heard me talking about the language.
You would just show me a promo here or there. And it would be, I'm going to kick your motherfucking ass, you motherfucking cocksucking piece of shit asshole, motherfucker, asshole. I'm like, that's not talent. Anybody can cuss a whole lot in a row. Like, I could cuss all night.
Right.
That's not talent, you know. But, Jesus Christ, that dude's got talent.
He's a great worker. I thought Tyler Breeze.
Oh, you just logged. I'm going to log you out. I'm sorry. I didn't know you had it back.
Don't even.
I just
keep it.
It's too late. You're going to get pulled right out.
Well, anyway, but if it comes back, we'll be good to go. But anyway, so we had a great time at NXT on Saturday night.
One it would have been better if I could have not, like, it's gay as shit to say what was bothering me. I had a tummy ache. That's really how you word it, too. Like, my stomach felt gross this morning from drinking warm beer and all that.
Right.
But that's just, like, yucky. This is like, like you wanted to just moan like a little baby and shit. That's how it was, like an actual ache, and it would not go away all night. Woke up the next day, I was fine.
Right.
Even when we got home, I'm still like, I couldn't even stand, and even sitting sucked. Like, nothing was comfortable, so it was not fun.
So in the last couple of weeks, or the last month or two, you've been to Monday Night Raw.
Yes.
You've been to NXT. I mean, we both agree that NXT was pretty good. Don't worry about the chat. I got it in here. But so we had a great time at NXT. Came home after the show, and to those that I said I was going to buy beer, I had every intention to buy you guys beer. I had cash on me.
Yeah.
There was no beer in the arena, and then we were going to go to Bombers after the show was over.
I fucked that up.
And Boom wasn't feeling well, so we wound up going back home and got back here. Continued the drinking when we got back here, but awesome time. Thank you again to Michael Schalick.
I just stashed him in my
pocket. Did
spot.
You?
Yeah. I did drink him the next day. But, yeah.
So anyway, all right. So we'll change pace here. Actually, you know what? We'll do Payback real quick.
Pretty old.
And then
now, yeah.
And then after we do Payback, we're gonna give you two exclusive news bits about Tammy Sitch. Doing Vivid and porn and everything else. And we're going to give you an update on TNA Impact Wrestling. What's the deal with Destination America? Has the show been canceled? I know a lot of people are tuned in tonight to hear what I found out earlier today about that. So we'll give that to you. Then we'll talk Monday Night Raw. Then in hour numero dos, we're going to be taking your live phone calls. I know Jackie has been all over me on Twitter. Wants to talk Rusev, Lana, and Ziggler. So
we might get a Norm MacDonald Letterman appearance out of her. She might cry.
We will bring Jackie on, and we will make it brief. I know we'll take one or two questions from her, and then get on to the next caller. But she does want to talk Rusev and Lana and Ziggler.
She's,
so we'll make it brief and move on.
She's and just because of this reason. I don't want her to get offended, because I'm not insulting her at all. I'm saying how she's perceived by the listeners is very comparable to Eric the Midget on Howard Stern.
She's very passionate.
Half the audience fucking thinks he's the greatest, and every time he calls, it's the most fun, entertaining segment of the show. The other half's like, get that piece of shit off the air. That's what happens. When she calls, half the chat's laughing and having a great time.
They love it.
Or they're just like, yeah, it's an interesting call.
You know what?
And the other half's like, who cares?
Jackie, in my opinion,
she is a
very...
She's real.
She's a good person. She's passionate
she's
about
real.
The product. She loves her wrestling.
Yeah.
She loves her Rusev. She loves her Lana. And
there's no phoniness.
She likes to call us on Tuesday or Thursday night. So I'm not going to... Some of you going to like her. Some of you are not going to like her.
I think she's
awesome.
Yeah.
I think she's great, man. So I'm not going to deny her the opportunity to talk to Rusev and Lana on here. And not only that, but she's a good person, man. She's a very good person.
And
so, been a loyal listener
you
for
can't
how many
really
years
say
now?
It because, you know, it's
I know.
Much, but to everybody else, there's obvious reason why her calls are entertaining. So,
right. So we'll have her on, hopefully. If you're listening tonight, here in our numero dos, but we're going to have on here a little bit. Make it brief.
Love
you. All right. Get to our live chat room, WZROnline.com/chat. Get in there. Lots and lots of people in there, as always, tonight. All right. WWE Payback from Sunday night. We had John Cena and Rusev. In an I Quit match.
We did.
We had Seth Rollins, Randy Orton, Roman Reigns, and Dean Ambrose for the WWE World Heavyweight title. We had Stardust and R-Truth on the pre-show.
Correct.
Which we'll start with right now.
Yeah.
Stardust and R-Truth. It was, I mean...
I didn't watch the pre-show, so I can't help you.
They kept it short, dude. R-Truth won clean with, what did they call it? The lie detector, I think, is what they call it. they kicked off the show,
was this the pre-show? No, second pre-show match.
Two pre-show matches.
Yeah.
All right. We had Macho Mandow And Axel Mania. Listen, Curtis Axel, I thought it was Hogan. Okay, I thought it was Hogan.
I gotta watch it. Well, I heard somebody else's.
Obviously,
show.
Without the pythons.
Yeah.
Curtis
they
Axel.
They said he had his mannerisms down. Dude. Like, even not just the talking and the thing, like in the ring, like just the way he was moving, supposedly looked very similar to Hogan.
Curtis Axel.
So he's good.
Was fucking money yeah. on the pre-show, dude. He was so.
Did he outshine
money.
Mandow? Because Damian Sandow.
I think so. I
he
think
does his
dude,
gimmicks. He's good, man.
I think so. That Randy Savage, Macho Sandow's
calling. Macho Mandow.
Macho Mandow. Yeah. Curtis Axel, man, with Axelmania, dude. Yeah. They brought him out to the entrances of Randy Savage and Hulk Hogan, right? I thought Curtis, I mean, people say, and I say it too, Curtis Axel doesn't have a lot of charisma, let's be honest, on the microphone, when he
there.
Cuts promos, but he's getting there.
Yeah.
He's getting there, right?
When he was with Heyman, that's why he was with Heyman. He couldn't talk. Now he's like, don't change the channel. He's got some funny shit now.
The Axelmania thing kind of took off.
Yeah,
and you know what?
In the ring.
He did that on his own, I think. He started the whole Axelmania thing, and I think WWE saw it catching on via social media, unless WWE told him to go out and do.
Because he was wearing a shirt and everything, so they would have had to block.
But I'm talking before, when it first started. When it first started.
I think it was a case like Sandow, where they just had him do it once, because just something to do tonight, and then it got over so well that they're like, let's have him do it for a while.
So I think what happened is he said, you know what, I really wasn't eliminated from the Royal Rumble.
Yeah.
And he went on Twitter and started this Axelmania campaign that
you know
I want to go to WrestleMania.
Okay, you know what,
and,
you're right.
And it started to catch on in
he
WWE.
He did start on his own on the internet, and then they let him do it on TV.
Yeah,
you're
and
right,
then,
I
and
forgot
then,
that.
And then WWE said, you know what, this Axelmania thing is kind of catching on here. And then they ran with it, and that's where we are today with Macho Mandow and Axelmania.
It's
but,
a little overdone at this point. I mean, you need to either go somewhere with it, or get rid of it, or change it, or whatever.
So we had, I mean, this is pure comedy.
Well, that was
dude.
A funny thing to do, to add Damian Sandow as Macho Man, do the mega powers with Hogan and Savage.
And Sandow's been doing this over the last couple of months, impersonating
people.
He's done
Bret Hart, he's done all of them. Yeah.
Right, so and this was pure comedy. They faced the Ascension. The Ascension gets a win, bro.
Well, that's what you would expect. I mean, the joke team versus the...
The joke team versus the
I was
going to
say the joke team,
team
versus the joke team, because the Ascension's a joke, but... I don't know, man. WWE really thinks they're promoting this tag team, The Ascension, and they're doing a god-awful job. I mean,
no, they only started promoting him at Payback. Other than that...
You know, when they first brought him in, the announcers were like,
oh,
they
think
they're as good as the Road Warrior. Are they fucking stupid?
Right.
Like, how are you going to get them over by immediately telling everybody, these guys aren't as good as these other teams?
Does that scare you where guys down in NXT are over so big in NXT, and then they bring them up to the main roster, and it's like they get the wrath of Vince McMahon. And
it's interesting to see which ones he likes and which ones he doesn't like.
He likes Neville.
Because, he's giving Neville a half a chance. But, I mean, they kind of started the...
That promo on Monday, though.
Who was it? Bo Dallas and Adam Rose, when they came in, the question was which one would get over.
Yeah.
Neither one of them got over.
No.
But then you look
no.
at the other, like the Wyatt family, they treated them like top acts right out of the gate.
Absolutely.
Kevin Owens, they're treating like he's fucking seen it up in his first appearance. Like,
I think Ambrose is kind of up now, too, man.
They're doing a little bit more with him.
They're doing a lot more with Ambrose. But
no, I'm just saying, it's interesting to see which guys. Triple H likes them all, has them all do their thing in NXT, and they all get over for whatever reason. Like Emma, when she came up, you had to have known. Okay, this is over in the NXT crowd.
Yeah, but
goofy
when it comes
not
to
gonna
them.
Get over.
Right,
like they're not
right.
gonna be going rabid wild because she's doing a goofy dance.
I know you didn't watch all of NXT Takeover Unstoppable last night. How hot did Emma look last night?
I heard
night?
She changed her look.
She looked completely. Becky Lynch is the one that really changed her look, but Emma. Last
was
night.
It Becky Lynch or Emma?
I don't know if it was more makeup. I don't know what happened with Emma, but Emma looked fucking good last night.
That was rewriting the report, and they said that she changed her ring attire and her hair. Emma did.
Emma?
Yeah.
That was Becky Lynch.
So he got the name wrong there.
Yeah.
That was pretty good report.
Yeah, it was Becky Lynch.
Yeah, alright.
But anyway, so back to Payback. Let's do this quick,
Dana
man.
Is, whoosh,
whoo, the blondie?
God.
Yeah, man.
Man.
And
who was the chick that was standing with the tag team when we first walked in?
Becky Lynch.
I don't think it was Becky Lynch. I think it was like...
Carmella?
Yeah, Carmella.
Carmella.
Yeah.
Man. She's a hottie, too.
Carmella and Dana Brooke?
Yeah.
Dana's in Vivid Sign Vim.
Yeah.
They're still hot. Sorry, Tate.
You know who's not Charlotte is kind of...
She's not that attractive at all.
Yeah,
I mean, she's in
I don't think so.
But she's not a very good-looking girl.
All right, we'll do this real quick, man, so
from
that we can get into...
Probably behind.
Absolutely. From behind, yeah. Absolutely.
Turn the lights out.
Tell that to Ric Flair.
Yeah, no thanks.
Tell that to Ric Flair.
No.
Dolph Ziggler and Sheamus kicked off the the live...
Beat up by a 70-year-old? Yeah.
I think Flair would whoop both of our asses. Yeah, no doubt. We had Dolph Ziggler and Sheamus kicked off the main WWE Payback pay-per-view. What did you think of this pay-per-view, Todd? I thought it was pretty good, man.
I don't even remember.
That was pretty good. We had Sheamus won with
now I'm starting to remember some shit. It was a good show.
The Shield mini reunion
that part was
in the
awesome,
main event.
I thought
was
that
great.
Was great.
That was great.
I thought the Cena Rusev thing was pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't say great, but damn good.
Shrug down the above, man. Sheamus won with a bro kick.
That was after Ziggler out of nowhere grabbed him and started headbutting the shit out of him.
Ziggler got busted open,
pouring.
Yeah.
I mean, like somebody turned a faucet on, just blah.
Yeah, yeah.
And they went right home.
Pretty crazy. They did go right home. They see blood, and if they know
the match and everything,
that they can't fix it with a...
And that was a clear case where they're not fixing that one. Yeah.
A lot of people accused Dolph Ziggler of blading.
No,
he put up a video.
God,
absolutely
no
blading there.
That's the kind of blood you see in a UFC fight where it's graphic.
Camera stayed away from Ziggler too, man. When he got real bloody,
and they had the guys come in and stop everything.
Yeah, man.
And then you know when they stop it, and the very first thing is, all right, finisher 1, 2, 3, without like, let's beat him up a bit, then do the finisher.
That was
so it's believable. Like,
yeah.
No, we need to get the hell out of here. This guy's bleeding like a pig.
Well, the problem is,
who cares?
No, you know what it is, dude. There's people in the front row, if they get a speck of blood on them, there's a lawsuit and a half. I got blood on me. Not that WWE would have HIV, but it's like,
but it could be anything.
Blood. If even a speck of blood gets on a kid in the front row, and when you're going like that to somebody, a speck of blood is gonna go places.
Oh man, I remember which fight was it where the announcer said? I remember. I think maybe Austin Bernhardt, where Jerry Lawler's notes got splattered in blood.
Yeah,
and he's got him saved like at his house.
Yeah,
blood all over him.
It's crazy. Seth Rollins and Kane are backstage, right? Kane's basically saying, I'm going to do what's right for business, but...
I got it all loaded up.
Damn it!
Giant letters and shit.
All right, no doubt.
But, it was basically Rollins talking to Kane, and basically trying to find out, is Kane going to help me tonight, or is he going to fuck me tonight? You know?
Right.
And Kane pretty much said, he didn't really reveal what he was going to do.
Basically, same thing that we've seen week after week. It's like, listen, dude, I could have cost you the title at Extreme Rules.
Yeah.
I didn't do that. Da, 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 da.
And he's very quick. So he's teasing it a very subtle way. He's teasing, I'm not going to help you at all. Like, he's like, I don't need this job. I've been saving my money for the last 20 years doing it. I could quit tomorrow. I don't need to work.
Right.
So don't try and strong arm me. I'm going to tell Triple H on you. I don't need this shit. You know,
this ain't gonna happen.
Up on it.
All right, no doubt. We had New Day, Tyson Kidd, and Cesaro. 2 out of 3 falls match for the tag team title. That was pretty good.
He's bigger, or is that good?
That's cool. That's cool. New Day.
Eye surgery. Can't read for shit.
Yeah. New Day retained. Xavier Woods, who was on the outside for most of the match, snuck in.
They did the old twin switcheroo at the end.
Right.
Even though
they're
not twins, that's a little racist. Like, oh, two black guys with ponytails and dreads, but.
They're pushing the New Day like crazy, man, because they did a bunch of backstage segments later in the show with the New Day where they were just all over the place, you know, saying, we retain the title. We had Ryback and Bray Wyatt. There wasn't a lot of hype going. I mean, it seemed like, all right, Bray Wyatt's cutting all these promos, this, that, and the other thing, and they're going to do a big thing with Bray Wyatt and Ryback, and this was just kind of thrown out there.
And I agree with you completely, but watching the video package, I distinctly remember watching the video package before that match and thinking they edited that in a way that really made Wyatt look awesome. And Ryback, for Ryback's part, you know, I think he's cheesy. He's like even a more muscled up John Cena. Like,
right.
Feed me. Oh, shut up, you douchebag. But
he cut a great promo a couple of weeks ago.
He did.
Cut a great promo.
Just last week, I think it was, but...
Had John Cena and Rusev in an I Quit match. Ryback won. You know what? That is Ryback defeated Bray Wyatt, and
No, Wyatt won.
Or Wyatt, I'm sorry. Sister Abigail. Right. John Cena Rusev, I Quit match. So, a couple of weeks ago, you came on here, and I remember you specifically saying, you said, you know what's going to happen? Lana is going to throw in the white towel. I had said...
I thought she was going to quit for him. Because you were saying, like, I'm going to quit you, like the wording. Some girls will say, I quit that nigga. Like, a black girl will say, I quit that nigga. You know what I mean? Like, it's a way of saying I broke up with him, I dumped him or something.
Okay.
I'm just using the slang, man. Okay. I'm not being offensive. I'm not trying to be offensive.
Use the A, I guess.
Yeah, there you go. I said it like 50 Cent instead of, like, Hitler. But, too extreme, right?
Okay.
But anyways, yeah, so, but yeah, you were thinking she was going to be like, I quit you, you know, like, that was going to be irony in the word I quit match and she quits him.
Rusev
and
I was said, gonna no, quit,
gonna
Lana quit. Was going to quit.
She's going to quit for him.
For him.
Cost him the match, and then he's going to get rid of her, she turns babyface, and man. That's what we've been hearing. She's going this way as a babyface.
She's going way up as a babyface. So, that's pretty much what happened. I mean, Rusev's in the middle of the ring, right, and... One thing I hated about this match is the referee. Do you quit? Do you quit?
Yeah.
Do you quit?
It's too much.
Every fucking, like, every 30 seconds. Do you quit?
Yeah.
Do you quit? Not so much of that. I get it. You gotta ask the question, right? But how about, you know, every couple of minutes?
Technically, you don't have to ask the question. I mean, they've established the fact that...
Yeah, just say, I quit.
No, tap out.
Right, I quit.
If you tap out, you quit. Or you say, like in the old days, like before tapping was a thing because of UFC, you're in the sharpshooter, they are, you give up. No. You see the hair shaking? No. And then finally, when the hair starts shaking this way, oh, ring the bell.
Right.
Yeah. Now, so every 2 minutes, do you give up? Do you quit?
And
the
over,
way you would always
over.
Listen to hear how they would respond, because they would just get like power bombed through a concrete thing and pyro explodes and he's burned and set on fire.
And they have like,
and do you quit? And he says, no! And I'm like, man, you're half dead. How do you got that much energy to be?
I mean, from the very beginning of the match, and then John Cena would be like, ask him, does he quit? And do you quit?
Have you ever
do
got you your quit? Ass beat before? In a real life fight?
I don't think I ever have. I mean, I've
not me busting nose.
Not,
I'm
not
talking about getting
out or anything.
Yeah,
no, I'm not knocked out or anything.
I have.
Okay.
You're not yelling no if somebody sticks a mic in your face and says, "Do you quit?" You're like, you know.
But anyway, so it winds up that Rusev at the end of the match in Russian or whatever he was saying,
Bulgarian,
yeah. Basically said, "All right, I quit." And Lana says, I quit, he quits. And then that was it. So Rusev gets all pissed off, and then that's all they did there. The following night on
Raw.
They
did a little backstage segment later in the pay-per-view, I think, with them.
Okay,
and
we'll go.
Her, like, get the fuck out of my locker room. You know,
right. It was.
But Raw was the angle, you're right.
And Raw was the angle where
the follow-up.
That's when everything played out. So, well, we'll get back to that here when we get into Monday Night Raw. Before we go to the break here, we're about to finish up Payback. I'm going to give you guys the sunny stuff, and then what we'll do is we'll go to a commercial break. As soon as we come back from the break, I'm going to give you guys the update on Impact Wrestling. So, that's what we'll do. We had the Bella Twins against Naomi and Tamina Snuka. Naomi pinned Nikki Bella, slammed her off the
top rope. I must have been doing something because I don't remember
the
damn thing about that match.
We had, this is the backstage segment. Rusev is furious about,
he just kicks her out of the locker room.
Kicks her out, says, get out, and then we'll get into
Raw
from Monday night. We had Neville against King Barrett, who,
a rematch of the King of the Ring finals.
A rematch, right,
right.
You know, it was right before the coming off a Divas match, and they're right before the main event. So,
it
wasn't a very good spot for them to be, but, we had Barrett rolled out of the ring, and Neville went up to the top rope. Barrett refused to get back into the ring and was counted out. And that was it, pretty much.
Was it a count out?
It was a count out.
I remember now. I just read it. After the match, then
Barrett came back in and hit the bull hammer. Neville was able to come back from that and eventually hit the red arrow.
Yeah.
Which is an awesome finisher, by the way.
It's the most flashy, entertaining finisher in the business.
On the main roster.
Like, what was it that
I think Finn Balor's pretty good.
Well, it's a double foot slam?
I love
compared
that.
Compared to the Red Arrow?
No, the Red Arrow? Absolutely. As far as like
back in the day when Petey Williams, who was that fucking guy in TNA that would do like a foot pile driver?
Canadian Destroyer.
Oh, man, that was insane. Like, there's always, every once in a while, there's a move that you watch and you're like, holy
shit.
Well,
and AJ Styles with Styles.
That's another one. And they're super dangerous moves. Absolutely. Like, that Red Arrow shit goes even a little bit wrong.
Crazy.
Or if they try and do the thing where he's flat out and he goes to do the Red Arrow and they stick the knees up.
Oh, man.
How do you know what part's coming
down?
It could be his fucking head coming down first. You don't know.
I would say that
with all this twisted,
you know,
shit.
We probably listed the three best finishers in pro wrestling right now with the Red Arrow by Neville, the Styles Clash, and Petey Williams.
Is he even around anymore, though, Petey Williams?
Petey Williams? No, he's retired. He actually retired.
Did he?
Actually announced his retirement, yeah. But I would say, you know what? I'd probably go Petey Williams, number one. I love that. I love that finisher.
Yeah.
I'd say Neville, number two. Styles, number three.
If we're ranking just those three, say, yeah, I'd have to put Petey above. Even the Red Arrow is so cool, but that fucking thing.
Petey
looks,
is
that
awesome. Yeah.
Canadian Destroyer looks so dangerous.
It
I would
is awesome.
Put it this way. If you're the opponent, which move would you least like to take?
Oh.
The Canadian Destroyer.
The Styles Clash is up there too, man.
That's
a lot
not
of people getting hurt,
bad.
Though.
You gotta be a dumbass to tuck your head the wrong way.
True.
You're coming right on your face. Why would you put your head down?
Right.
But that Canadian Destroyer, if somebody said, no, I know what I'm doing, just here, just let me. Fuck you. You're not hitting me with that.
I don't know, man.
No.
I don't know about that.
No.
Alright, and then the main event of Payback was the Fatal 4-Way.
Yeah.
We had Wade Barrett.
I wonder if that kid in Canada ever did the Canadian Destroyer to his girl, because he's Canadian.
Yeah, yeah.
So he might like it a lot, because, you know, it's his hometown guy.
Might.
Like, yeah, I'm going to hit you with a Canadian Destroyer.
I don't know.
What's that mean?
Oh,
just come here. Put your head between my legs, and here, ready?
Know.
Oh, God, man.
I think his name was, I want to say, Savez. S-A-W-E.
S-A-W-E?
Or S-A-W-V. S-A-V-W-E. S-A-V-W-E.
S-A-V-W-E.
Savoy.
S-A-V-W-E. Never heard that name in my life. Who is he, French-Canadian?
French-Canadian.
Was he?
From Montreal.
Oh, so cool. I wonder if he could speak French.
Sure, he probably
like
can.
Like GSP.
From Montreal, that's French-Canadian.
Son of a bitch.
All right, so the main event, Seth Rollins, Randy Orton, Roman Reigns, and Dean Ambrose. This was awesome.
It was great.
There was one point where they were on the outside, and you had Dean Ambrose, Roman Reigns, and Rollins. They were on the outside, and Ambrose and or all three of them teamed up and put Randy Orton through the table.
Triple power bomb that they used.
Just very the triple power bomb.
And
that
afterwards,
was done.
Reigns and Ambrose are kind of celebrating, and Rollins like jumps
comes
behind
out like the buddy,
and he's like, yeah, and then he puts his hand out. Come on, guys, come on. And they both just stopped and like.
No.
No.
That was a cool spot, man. That was a really cool spot.
That was so cool just to see that little reuniting thing just in the middle of the mat. Like, it was
It really was cool.
It was cool. And on paper, it might look like a disaster. Like, no, he's your top heel.
Right.
You don't want him to give off the impression that he wants these two guys to like him.
But they did it so quick, and then the way... Yeah.
They did it perfectly.
Yep.
And not only did they write it or book it perfectly, like the idea...
Right.
The guys, the three guys, executed it perfect.
Absolutely.
Like, Rollins had just enough of an over-excited, like, all right, he's going a little too far with his happiness that his guys that beat the shit out of him turned on are finally like, we're doing a move together.
Yeah, exactly.
And it was perfect.
All right, so obviously Seth Rollins wound up retaining there at one point.
With the pedigree, I think.
With the pedigree.
Yeah,
he used Triple H's pedigree. Didn't Triple H come out after the match?
Yes, on the ramp.
Right. There was one spot where Orton hit the RKO on Noble Mercury, hit a DDT on Rollins as well. The table spot that we talked about earlier, it was cool. So, overall, I thought Payback was pretty freaking good, man.
It was great.
I thought it was a good show. It was a really good show,
A good show. Now that we just went through it, I kind of remember the night now. And I remember before it started, I was like, God, I don't feel like doing this shit tonight.
Right.
Pays a lot of work. But especially when you know, all right, I got to do this tonight. The night before, I had to do a UFC. So, UFC,
and we went
Payback,
to
Raw, and then NXT on Wednesday.
Well,
I had to do King of the Ring the week before on a Wednesday.
Wasn't,
like,
the night before, I mean, UFC aired earlier in the day. I mean, obviously, we went to NXT on Saturday.
You know what, you're right, I didn't cover that.
In the morning.
I covered it,
you
but...
You did quick
yeah.
results. So, that actually aired in the morning. By the way,
yeah.
Mark Munoz?
He had a great retirement.
That was awesome.
Yeah,
match,
he had a great
little, everything else sucked.
The fight was good. He was landing big bombs, and then the post-fight, retiring interview
yeah.
in my hometown of the Philippines.
Where he took off the gloves and put them in the middle of the
that
ring.
Was
that was cool.
Really
that was
cool.
Awesome.
Really cool.
Yeah. But, all right.
Now,
so
the main event, Frankie Edgar, Uriah Faber.
Sucked.
Not
sucked,
so much,
dude.
Not so
no.
much. And I was really jacked for that fight.
A lot of people were.
Yeah.
A lot of people were. So that was WWE Payback from this past Sunday, which is a school letter grade. I'd say a solid B+. Plus.
B.
V?
Yeah.
All right. No doubt. All right. So what we're going to do, we're going to talk Sonny. Right, Tammy Sitch. We got about 5 minutes to talk about that. What's going on with her and Vivid and everything else? We're gonna take a commercial break. The second we get back from the commercial break, I'm gonna give you guys a big exclusive update on TNA Impact Wrestling. Is are they canceled? Are they not canceled? What's their status? What's their future with Destination America? I'm gonna give it to you when we come back from the commercial break. Following that, we're going to talk Monday Night Raw. We're going to make it brief. We're going to fly through it. We're going to talk NXT TakeOver Unstoppable from last night. We're going to take your rapid-fire questions. We're going to get Jackie on here. We're going to take your live phone calls. Hour number two is going to be packed, and we're going to kick it off with some exclusive news about TNA Impact Wrestling and their future on Destination
America. I like
how
you ran it down. Each thing was a different segment, and then one of the different segments was, and Jackie's going to call. He's already blocked out 5 minutes.
Tammy Sitch.
Yeah.
Sonny. A lot of you guys, Sonny, back in the day. We all had a crush on her back in the day. We all loved her, right?
It's a graphic line,
awesome.
But I'll repeat it.
Fucking A.
I used to break my dick jerking off to Sonny when I was.
We had her.
Who didn't?
We had her live.
Most
on
downloaded
this
chick on
show.
The internet.
On this
yeah.
show. Less than 2 months ago, we had her on here.
Randomly, she just called up.
She called up, and
I think you tweeted her during a commercial, and
tweeted
she
her,
called
and
right up. Yeah.
There she was. So here's the deal.
What's
rumors
the deal?
Come out. A guy, an MMA guy, MMA Brian or whatever his
front
name
row
is,
Brian.
Front
we,
row Brian.
We're about to hire him.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
All right. He has broken some stories on Twitter, and he said that Tammy Sitch, Sonny, had signed a deal with Vivid Entertainment.
The same company, TMZ, China.
Did
the
her
big company of porn, yeah.
TMZ is very close with Stephen Hirsch. To be honest with you, I think they got a little side deal.
The TMZ.
Where they promote him and he gives... I don't know. But they're always promoting... They're always promoting sex tapes.
Yeah.
Like, listen, Courtney Stodden. Who is Courtney Stodden? Who?
I have no idea.
Who? Courtney Stodden... just got paid $1 million to do a sex tape. And
who?
She, Courtney Stodden, is a woman that claimed that she was 16 years old, she was dating a 40 or 50-year-old man, and she tried to become a reality star. She failed, but she's a hot blonde chick. So she goes out and makes a sex tape. It's a self
Wow, you just explained
pleasure,
who she is? I still don't know who she
a
is.
A self-pleasure sex tape. She wasn't involved with... There were no dicks
she
involved.
She finger banged herself. Or was it a dildo?
There were no dicks involved. I don't know. I haven't seen,
seen
the tape. Okay. But they paid her $1 million. So
they paid her $1 million to play with herself?
$1 million.
Jesus Christ.
The problem is, if somebody makes a sex tape, you need both sides to sign off for it to be released.
To, yeah, to sell it and make money.
To get it out there, and she signed off on it. So Sonny has apparently...
We gotta talk about the Hogan thing, too. They're suing the FBI over that shit. All right.
So Sonny has apparently been offered a six-figure deal.
No,
which
seven.
Six.
Six would be like $600,000, $500,000, $800,000. I heard it was $1 million or more.
Deal. It's not $1 million.
Okay.
And that's what surprised
that's
me.
That's what I heard.
As Courtney Stodden was offered a seven-figure deal, $1 million. Sonny is only being offered a six-figure deal, which surprised me because she's a WWE diva, but TMZ came out and confirmed six-figure deal.
Much bigger
TMZ,
name, too.
Much bigger name.
I thought
exactly.
The TMZ quote was monster porn contract. Did they say
six,
the figure? Okay.
Six-figure deal. I'm positive. Because
and I wrote it, so I probably have an article with my name on it that says six-figure.
You guys
I just have a bad memory.
You guys will confirm that in the chat room.
I'm not arguing.
But six-figure deal, right? So she comes out, and if you look closely at her Facebook and her Twitter, she hasn't denied that she's doing it. She basically says, don't believe the nonsense and this, that, and the other thing. Fact of the matter is, she's been in talks with Vivid. No deal has been signed. TMZ reported that they are very, very close. They are very, very close.
Here's what it is.
She's going to go all out. She's going all in.
Yeah.
There's going to be sex tapes. It's coming sooner than later.
Listen.
And it's coming.
She's doing webcams with fans, and she straight told us on these airwaves that she will dick around with you on the camera for like $10. So, of course, if someone says, how about we give you a couple hundred grand and you do it on camera and we sell it? She seems desperate enough for money right now.
She's got
a drug problem and not a career anymore. Like, you need money.
Right.
To buy drugs. Drugs are expensive.
That's on you, not me. I didn't say that.
All right, but drugs aren't expensive. I mean, everybody knows that. You don't need to be a drug addict to know that. But point being, I think the six-figure thing, I think the Courtney, whoever...
It's six figures for the tape and then royalties after that.
Well, here's my thing. The Courtney thing was a one-time thing, right? She just did the one video.
Mm-hmm.
I remember this part. The Sitch thing is a multi-year deal.
She's going to do multiple
videos. So it'd probably be six figures per thing. So if you add it up, it would be a couple million if you do a bunch
of videos.
And then
depending on sales, she's going to have royalty. She's going to have royalty checks month after month after month.
Yeah.
So she's going to. It's going to make her a killing. She's going to become a multi-million dollar person.
Porno star.
She's gonna make millions of dollars when this thing is all said and done.
Is she in shape right now?
She gained a little bit of weight, but
because I remember she got back in shape for the Hall of Fame, but then
she
passed out somewhere during a signing or something. I remember she was like fat again. So.
Yeah, she got big. Like me. So. All right, so here's the deal. That's the deal. Listen, a Sunny sex tape. I'm guaranteeing it's coming.
Yeah.
All she's got to do is sign the dotted line. I'm sure they're just working out the. Kinks.
That's what I think. When she's kinks. Denying that, I haven't signed anything, is what she said. I haven't signed anything.
Right.
All she's pretty much doing is saying, it's not official yet.
She's trying to hype it up.
But it's legit. She does this all the time. She denies shit that's 100% true.
And then it comes out and then it's true. And
eventually she's like, well, it wasn't true at the time. And that's what she's doing right now. No, when you guys were saying I hadn't signed anything.
It wasn't true. I didn't sign it, but now I have.
Nobody said you did. We said you were close
exactly.
to it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That's exact. She's going to sign with Vivid. The sex tapes are coming. There's going to be multiple ones. A lot of porn stars came out and said they'd love to work with her. And it's coming sooner than later.
Yeah.
Trust me.
I wonder if she's going to do any lesbian shit. That'd be hot.
Sure, she's down. Listen, it's coming. She just hasn't signed on the dotted line. Within the next month or two, it'll be official, and I promise you
guys
that.
I guarantee
it. Anyways, we are going to take a quick commercial break. On the flip side, we're going to come back, and we're going to open our numero dos with TNA Impact Wrestling. Are they done with Destination America? Are they not done? What's the deal? There were reports last night. Destination America has canceled TNA Impact Wrestling. As soon as we get back from this break, that's what we're starting with. Submit your rapid-fire questions for our numero dos. Tell them, Matty Boone, how they can submit rapid-fire questions.
You to tell them?
I'd love for you to tell them.
Pretty simple. I mean, you just go to Facebook.com/RyanClarkWCO. That's Facebook.com/... Ryan Clark WZR. Once you get there, top post will ask you your questions and comments for the rapid fire segment and our numero dos. We will answer them in a rapid fire style fashion. So that means please keep them brief so we're not sitting here reading all night long. Facebook.com/ Ryan Clark WZR.
You're listening to WZR TV Tuesdays with Matt Boone.
Me.
Ryan Clark. We'll be back right after this talking Impact Wrestling, Destination America. They didn't hear it.
They weren't watching.
They said they didn't even hear it. So that big old shout out that I gave them an hour.
Pointless.
No, it was pointless anyway. But anyway, if you're listening now, shout out to Brian and Mandy over in Manans. Right
over
here.
I got a glimpse when you opened it. Brian's like a big motherfucker, huh?
He is a beast.
He's a horse.
And he's a shit talker. And he thinks he's a tough guy. He's a tough guy. I'll whoop his any dick.
He says.
And he knows that. he actually beat the fuck out of me. But
he's huge when you open the door. And I only got like a half
boy
glimpse of him, and I'm like, whoa, that's a tank outside.
I'll tell you what, he is a good guy to have on your side.
Is he a big teddy bear, or is he a fucking vicious beast?
He's a big teddy bear to the people that know him.
Okay.
He is a good guy to have on your side if you have a problem with somebody else.
If you treat him right, he's a nice guy. If you don't, you better have a fucking baseball bat very close
to him. He knows I love him. He's been a friend for years, man, so he's a good deal. All right, so props to them for listening. Props to all of you guys for listening on a special Thursday night edition of WZV. So, told you guys when we came back on the flip side, we're going to kick this thing off with TNA Impact Wrestling, and that's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to do a very fast rundown of both Monday Night Raw and NXT TakeOver Unstoppable from last night. Take your rapid-fire questions. Just put that up on my Facebook, facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. You guys can go over there, submit your rapid-fire questions, and you'll be good to go on that. And live phone calls with Jackie and a couple of you other guys on here in just a little bit. So,
confused about this computer, man. It cuts off, but now it's okay. Like, what the hell causes it?
I was stepping on a cord down
maybe
here.
That's it. Maybe you accidentally unplugged it a little bit?
I don't know, man.
It happened many times.
That's weird. Yeah. Alright, so
it's my computer. If I leave here, this is what I have to
use. I know.
Last night, I'm taking this shit, but it's coming with me, guys. I'm telling you right now.
So last night, every Wednesday night, a guy by the name of Dave Meltzer, a very credible wrestling source. I know some people criticize Dave, and some people don't like Dave.
Who?
Some people criticize me, some people don't like me.
Yeah.
It's just the way the wrestling industry works. But Dave Meltzer is a credible source.
He's the veteran journalist in our field.
He is the founding father
of our business.
Right.
Like, he started it as a mail service. He would mail a fucking newsletter out.
Before
the internet existed. He's doing it in the 80s.
Right.
And then when the internet came along, we came along and kind of took it to the next level.
Basically, every Wednesday night on F4WOnline.com, Dave Meltzer releases the Wrestling Observer Newsletter. Been going on for 15, 20 years now. During last night's issue of the Wrestling Observer, there was a news bit in there that basically indicated that Destination America was planning to cancel TNA Impact Wrestling. A lot of people say, how can Destination... Well,
let me clear that part up, because you got the follow-up exclusive.
Go ahead.
The story that Meltzer told was basically, he didn't indicate or allude to it. He outright, flat-out said, they canceled all TNA programming. It won't be effective until September when they release their new fall primetime lineup. And they don't want advertisers to not buy time, because that September's to what, 5 months away?
Mm-hmm.
4 or 5 months away. So they don't want the numbers, the ad numbers, the rating numbers. Like, they don't want numbers to bomb in the next 5 months because they're stuck with them.
Right.
But when they release their new thing, they're gone.
Right.
That's the report, and then you got the thing.
So that is the report, and right off the bat, a lot of people say, well, I don't believe it, you know, it's not true.
I believe it.
Show me proof, that, and the other thing. A lot of people say, well, wait a minute, TNA signed a 2-year deal with Destination America. How can they get out?
Real quick, here's the confusing part to the newer fans. Like, they're like, they just announced they're changing nights to Wednesday. What, they're canceling, but they're going to give them a new time slot before they cancel? Like, why would they even do that?
And that's going to play into what I'm about to tell you. That's a good point you made.
I know what I'm doing.
It was a great point.
Take the ball and run.
So a lot of people say, well, how? Oh, wait a minute. They signed a 2-year contract with Destination
America.
They
just signed it.
So how
can
they get
out? 2 months, right?
They have a clause. January,
right?
Not that long. Yeah.
January is where they debuted. Yeah. So it's only been a couple months.
There is a clause in the 2-year contract.
They got a backdoor out of it.
Destination America can get out of that 2-year deal come the fall of the first year.
Based on this or that. And
based off this or that,
advertisers. Advertisers the big one. Apparently, advertisers don't want shit to do with buying time on that show. So.
Exactly. Yeah. So, You gotta think about this. When TNA came off Spike TV, they were drawing 1.1, 1.2, 1.3 million viewers every week. That would translate into a 0.08 or a 0.9.
Well, they would even do. I thought you had it backwards, and then you corrected it. But they were actually doing 1.1, 1.2 ratings.
Right.
Too.
Right.
So that's like, you know, 1.5 million people.
So you get
as high as that. And
yeah, you get
average.
One,
they would get like
1.4, 1.5. Yeah. You know what I mean? Million viewers.
That would be
so.
Amazing.
The hope was that those viewers would come over to Destination America. Obviously, Spike TV is a much bigger network than Destination America is. Okay.
Is this true? Robbie, aka Crazy Roller, and Slayery. They're both saying that TNA, or Dino UK, I'm sorry, they both say TNA the week after.
They put their full
episode
on YouTube.
They put the whole episode on YouTube? That would piss me off if I'm paying millions of dollars in rights fees.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Motherfucker, that's our only exclusive program. Get that shit off.
So the hope was that those viewers from Spike TV would translate over to Destination America.
Yeah.
Now, Spike TV is available in more homes than Destination America.
A lot more homes.
But Destination America is a fairly decent network. It's a newer network.
It's a newer network it could become another, depending on the program.
It could, depending on the program.
Like Sci-Fi did. Sci-Fi was a joke until they started, they changed the science fiction to SYFY.
Right.
And made it a real network that we could do anything, not just goofy alien shit.
So when TNA put their pitch into Destination America, it was like, look, we've got all these fans, we can bring them to your network.
Spike TV would be another example. TNN was a joke. And,
right. Yeah. Over the last couple of months, the ratings have come out, you know, and some weeks it's 400,000, some weeks it's 500,000, you know, I think the highest is like 600,000 or something. They did a live Impact broadcast. Now,
about half of what they used to do,
and that's a drop.
They were buying that show thinking, well, diehard off that, they'd Spike TV all these different nights, all these different times, and they'd always do at least a million. Probably thinking, we're going to get 900,000 to a million viewers a week.
Let me just say this in the chat room, because this is going to go for a little bit with Boone and I going back and forth. We're probably going to have to kind of skip Monday Night Raw, but you guys all saw that anyway. If we want to get rapid fire on live phone calls and everything else in.
What happened on Raw? Because I don't remember it at all.
I was going to depend on you because
the Owens
I wasn't
and Cena
here.
And all
I
that.
I wasn't here.
Yeah, you were for Owens and Cena.
I was here for that.
You did miss the first.
I'll tell you what. We'll do like the opening segment.
I'm remembering it now.
The Owens, Cena, and the main event.
Okay.
We'll do those three so that we can kind of get. But,
God, my memory sucks. Gee, that was just fucking 2 nights ago.
So the deal here is the ratings haven't been what TNA promised, if you will, or indicated to Destination America.
It wasn't what they were expecting.
It wasn't what they were
expecting. But it's not that much lower. So I heard it wasn't so much a ratings thing as it was an advertiser thing, and ratings was part of it, but it was mainly we can't generate money off this show the way we thought we were going to be able to.
Right. So
and ratings play into that.
So basically, where this leads is we've put up on the websites that Destination America has not been very happy with Impact and the ratings that they're drawing.
Well, let's get right into it. We put on the websites, they're canceling TNA. You heard otherwise.
So, the deal here is, we also put on the websites within the past week that...
Don't reveal the source when you say that.
No.
Sometimes you do. Okay.
No. So, late last week, Destination America management officials flew down to Nashville, Tennessee, the headquarters of TNA.
Yeah.
They met with TNA's creative team. We put that up on the websites. Billy Corgan, Dixie Carter. I know.
Billy
Corgan is getting really high praise on TNA. So
I think that's because of all marks for Smashing Pumpkins. But.
They met with TNA officials in Nashville, Tennessee, and there were some discussions about how can we get these numbers up. What can we do? Do we need more advertising? What can we do to get these numbers up? And coming out of the meeting, it was a 2-day meeting. Destination America,
I'll let you go.
Destination America, and TNA officials met for 2 days straight. What can we do to better the product? Now, in TNA's defense, over the last couple of months, TNA's product has been really fucking good,
been good,
man. It has been.
You realize we've got Destination, right? So have you been watching?
It's channel 115. I watched it for the last 3 weeks.
Okay,
I started with a live show, or 2 weeks. I started with a live show a couple of weeks ago, and I've watched it from that point forward after
years.
I found Destination America. TNA's product has been much, much better. It's just getting people to tune in. So, there were meetings over the past week, two-day meetings with TNA's creative team, Destination America. When we came on here, they don't... It's basically a situation of Destination America has until the fall to get that clause out of the way. A stern warning was sent from Destination America officials to TNA management that we've got to get these numbers to increase and we've got to do it by the fall. So if the numbers don't go up, that's the only way I know how to... So
that's his
if there's not an increase by the fall, Destination America is going to wind up canceling Impact Wrestling. They don't want this out, as you said earlier, as it's still 4 or 5 months away.
They've still got to make money off this show.
And they've got to make money. They don't want advertisers leaving. All indications now are that Destination America officials do not think, even with a move to Wednesday night. Now, in TNA's defense, Friday night is a terrible night for television.
Either. Wednesday, they're going to be going against NXT. They're going to be going against Lucha Underground.
But Wednesday's better than Friday.
Yeah, but they've got direct competition against the other two secondary leagues.
So, it's basically... All right, the reports last night basically said that Destination America had canceled TNA Impact.
Yes.
Destination America has not canceled TNA Impact as of right now.
Yeah.
And they basically, during the two-day meetings that took place within the past week, they basically gave them an ultimatum that come the fall, if these numbers are still where they are right now, we're done.
Yeah.
We're out. And if they rise with a change to Wednesday nights, if the numbers go up, if there's more advertising, if we can better this product, then we will reevaluate at that time and keep you.
Now
Destination America officials don't think this is going to happen come the fall.
It's not.
So,
but
and it's probably not going to happen.
It's not.
So, with that being said, it looks like Impact Wrestling is done with Destination America. Then Bob Ryder comes out today, and he says people have been saying for 13 years that TNA is going to go out of business. That's not what was put on the website last night. Never said anything about TNA going out of business. Said that TNA was going to lose their television deal come the fall.
ROH has the most shit television deal of all time, and they stay in business just fine. They would have to change the business model. They can't be an aggressive, we're number two company anymore. They'd have to be a different kind of company. But they don't need TV or a strong TV. They could get some syndicated bullshit like ROH Sinclair, you know, whatever kind of thing.
Something like that, right?
Yeah, so my two questions to you, since you're very in on and you've been following the story. A, September, October, August, September, October. All right, so October, since September's the talk, and it's supposedly the
last... It's the end of September.
The last,
it's
the
last
week of September is when
September.
The thing's supposed
the
to be made.
The last week of September.
It's supposed to be made. So my two questions to you, I guess I'll go in order. A, will the change to Wednesday nights be a successful change that will stop this from happening? And B, Friday night, Wednesday night, any night of the week, basically your gut feeling, are they done with Destination?
I think come the fall of October, I think.
If you tune the channel 150, gone. Whatever you said on October, whatever the Wednesday is.
I think they're gone. TNA and I think there was a very stern warning sent to TNA that...
Yeah.
If this doesn't change, and if we can't get above 400,000, 500,000 people on a weekly basis, even with a move to Wednesday nights, and that was TNA's case. Wait a minute, you guys are putting us on a Friday night. You're putting us on Friday night, which is probably Friday and Saturday are the worst nights for television on cable TV.
Especially for a show with a young demographic. Because if you remember back to when, like you said, we're getting old as fuck now, but when you're in your late teens, early 20s, and you got school or work or whatever, the only chance you get to have a life is Friday night and all day Saturday.
Right.
And Friday night's when they air, so obviously their target demo audience, the young males, They're not sitting at home watching TV on a Friday night.
TNA goes to Destination America and says, you got us on a Friday night. That's a terrible time. It's a terrible time for us to air. Give us a chance
on
Wednesday.
Did they say that, or did they want the Friday?
No, that was Destination America.
Because they said Friday, and TNA was like, really, Friday?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, I didn't know that part.
So TNA says, well, you got us on Friday night. Let us try Wednesday. Let us show you what we can do on Wednesday. Now,
I think
course,
it's a last-ditch effort kind of thing.
It's absolutely... All
right, we got till September, and you're getting rid of us, right? Well, what if we... Give us another night, and then maybe...
Give us Wednesday night, and let us show you what we can do on a Wednesday night.
It's a desperation Hail Mary...
Hail Mary attempt to say, switch us from Friday to Wednesday, and Destination
America... Give us a realistic... Wednesday's
America,
wrestling night, NXT, Lucha...
Destination America says, all right. Let's do it. We'll take you from Friday. We'll move you to Wednesday.
You 4 months to build your audience?
If going from Friday to Wednesday, if nothing happens...
If
and
it's not
and
a dramatic change...
The numbers
and even by dramatic would only mean like an extra 100,000, 200,000 viewers.
Right.
That's like 20, 30% increase in viewership, which is huge.
Right. So it's
especially
it
for
comes,
a new cable company.
It comes down to, listen, I love TNA, Ring of Honor, WWE, the more promotions, Global Force Wrestling, the more... Listen, we all love wrestling, right? All you guys that are watching, you all love wrestling, right? We want to see more wrestling. Competition is good.
It's healthy.
For business. We need competition. WWE is this standalone company right now, and then you've got TNA, Ring of Honor, GFW coming up. Way down here, right? And WWE is a standalone. We need competition, and the more competition, the better the product for everybody. Yes,
well,
but it's just a case of TNA is basically, they're not going to admit this. And let me say this, TNA issued a statement today threatening legal action about these reports online. Here's the deal, Destination America has not told TNA that we're going to cancel your show. They didn't say that at the meetings this past week. They basically insinuated that... Listen, if things don't change, we're going to have to take some sort of drastic measures.
That's the exact wording I would have used, too.
To, you know, it's not, hey, listen, come this fall, if your ratings don't go up...
Yeah. You hit this number, or you're gone. I think it was more of a, they alluded to it strongly.
It's
things aren't really working out as great. What do you guys have in mind to make things better? We got till September when we have to release our new schedule. What can we do to get this to where we thought it was going to be in the first place, or where you said it was going to be, whatever the case. I don't know who said what or whatever. But, yeah. So, my other question, or my other statement was going to be the competition thing. A, TNA, at its peak, was never competition to WWE. Competition means you're taking audience from this company and putting it into your company. WCW was competition.
Mm-hmm.
They would steal views. People would change the channel from Raw over tonight, that's competition.
Right. Back and forth, back and forth.
Nobody was like, oh, TNA or WWE. It was, there's 4 million hardcore WWE fans in North America. About a million of them are just diehard pro wrestling fans, so they'll watch anything.
Right.
That's not competition. That's just a diehard fan that'll watch any product you put out there. It's not like they're choosing between one or the other.
But
the other thing was, since I let you go forever, was the your scoop, and I don't think I'm revealing too much. If I am, I apologize, but... You didn't get it from the management side. You got it from the talent side.
From a talent
it was
side.
It was some wrestlers you talked to.
It was
well-respected, well-known wrestlers. But, so they probably wouldn't be as knowledgeable on the situation because, you know, management, like when they were losing Spike TV, they would not admit it to the roster.
They would not admit.
They lied to the roster.
You remember that? When they were leaving Spike TV,
it was supposed to be a meeting every Tuesday, next Monday.
It's not happening. Yeah. We're not leaving Spike. And then what happened?
Like a week later. Oh, they're gone.
What happened?
Yeah.
They wound up leaving Spike.
So my last
the
point.
Same thing.
Yeah, it's happened over again. So my last point was, forget the competition. We need companies like TNA, Global Force, so that guys have jobs. Guys like the people you talk to have a place to work,
absolutely.
Ply their trade, make a living.
But it's like, all right.
So you don't have to sign a Vivid Entertainment contract to buy a fucking house.
TNA, so the whole report
that was worth
a
fake laugh.
Impact Wrestling.
He wasn't even listening.
Being canceled. Impact Wrestling.
Yeah.
What did you say?
I said they need a place to work so they can make a living. Otherwise, they got to sign like a fucking Vivid Entertainment contract to buy a house, you know. I said, fake laugh, motherfucker. I'm not going to make you barrel over, but what a smile. You didn't even crack a smile. I saw your shit, asshole.
That was a fake laugh.
Yeah.
Did you like that?
After this story, I fucking, yeah.
I love this fucking. All right. So anyway, it's a case of, has Impact Wrestling been canceled by Destination America?
Not officially, no. But is it coming? That is was my coming? Question to you. Do you think it's going to happen?
I think so. Even the move to Wednesday night, I don't think the numbers are going to go up that much.
So everybody signs with Global Force Wrestling. Jarrett does it all over again.
I know.
It's like, just like he did in 2002.
Could be.
And you buy GFWWrestlingNews.com instead of...
Exactly. I don't know what
are you going to do with that?
I don't know what I'm going to do with my TNA site. I have started to cover GFW
well, what you
and,
do
and
is
indie promotions on
just
TNA.
Just cover anybody that's ever worked in TNA on the site.
That's what I'm doing.
And just be like, here's what they're doing these days, you know.
That's exactly what I'm doing right now, man. But it's a case of, all right, so as of right now, what happened here? As of right now, TNA Impact Wrestling has not been canceled by Destination America. Thus, the statements by Bob Ryder, thus the statements by TNA Wrestling saying, we have not been canceled. These are completely false claims. Destination America has not come out and said, we are canceling the product. They're basically giving them one more chance. You got until the fall to prove us wrong. We're going to move you guys to Wednesday nights from Friday. Yeah. You got one chance to up these rings. If it happened by the fall, we are going to cancel you, although
and
they have not outright said that.
Yes.
TNA.
Here's the
thus
thing.
Thus, why TNA is denying
it. And it's why they're reports. Denying it. It's why Bob Ryder's pissed about it. Here's a little something about reporting. They can't flat out tell them you're gone in September.
No, they
there's
can't.
There's contracts, there's legal issues that prevent them from being like, yeah, well, last week of September, you're gone. I don't give a fuck.
Correct.
Pull a 1.2 for your next fucking 3 months straight.
Can't do it.
We don't fucking want you.
Right.
We can't sell ads on this goddamn show no matter what you do.
Right.
You're not what we thought you were. We're getting rid of it. We have an option to get in it. We're getting out of it. For some reason, legally, they can't say it. But when you talk to a reporter that tells you, yes, I will keep your name off the record, but can I report the name? Yeah, as long as you don't say a name, there's no legal anything there unless you get caught being the guy doing it. So that's why it's a situation where the reporters sometimes know more than the people in the company themselves. Like,
correct.
They don't even know that it's this official yet.
And
they hear the rumblings like everybody else, but they're like, well, no, we just had a meeting for 2 days.
Y'all right now.
Everything's fine.
Y'all right now can say that I don't believe this.
Wait till October.
Come talk to us in the last week of September, early
first
October,
week of October,
and we will see where TNA... It's come the last week of September, the first week of October.
Yeah.
Is TNA Impact still on Destination America?
Their last show will probably be the last
week
of
September. I can tell you right now that based off the meetings and based off the ultimatums given, I don't think come the last week of September and October, unless there is a drastic change in the ratings
and, why would
and
it
a
be?
Big increase...
Yeah.
When they move to Wednesday
what
night,
what could they do that would
they're
change
not
it
gonna
that
be,
big?
They're not going to be on Destination America come this fall.
You said,
and that's it.
They
that's,
do 400 to 600. They would essentially, not essentially, they would literally
have to do about 900,000 to a million.
Damn near double their viewership.
Pretty much, man.
In the next couple of months, what the hell could they do to do that?
And
they,
move
TNA,
to a
they
Wednesday
signed,
night's not going to do
yeah,
that.
Yeah, they signed Hulk Hogan, Eric Bischoff, all these huge names, Sting, all these guys, and they went head to head with Raw, and they. Still couldn't fucking draw
it's
a big, you know, they can't tour shit because nobody buys tickets to TNA.
Let me say one more thing. Let's say that TNA does lose their deal with Destination America. That's not to say that TNA's going out of business.
No, they can still make money in England.
They can sign with another network, for crying out loud.
As
they
long
can
as their international TV and distribution and merchandise is strong,
right,
all they
right.
need is a basic platform in America.
And don't think for one second.
Internet might even be strong.
Don't think for one second that TNA's not going to go try and negotiate with other agencies. Not only that, but here's another thing.
They probably
is
are.
Destination America just recently canceled. TNA Unlocked. That show is done with the network starting next week. No more TNA Unlocked. TNA
never even
been,
heard of that show.
TNA has been reshuffling their live event dates. I know the UK tour is still on.
That's where they make money.
There's a lot of changes that are happening in TNA, and they're not going to come, and they're going to deny, just like they did.
The public's
just like they did with Spike TV, and you all know what happened with Spike TV. The same thing is happening with Destination America right now.
Yeah, only this time.
Deny, 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 and then what happens?
Only this time it's a little more severe. To get kicked off of a network like Spike TV, not kicked off, but like not renewed, that's one thing.
Yeah.
Get kicked off, not renewed, they still got a year or two on this.
Yeah, they got, it's
so they're literally getting kicked off. They're getting out of their contract. We don't even want to finish our deal with you.
Right,
it's
right.
So bad. And this is a small company compared to Spike.
Right.
So it's going to be hard for if you're TNA management to go negotiate with other cable networks and get any kind of deal worth a shit. Because what's your leverage? Like, we just got canceled by Destination America.
I know.
And of course, whoever you're talking to is going to be, who? Destination what?
Right.
Canceled you? In the middle of your deal? Like, I don't want to sign you then. Get the fuck out of my office.
I'm not even going to bring up the Monday Night Raw review. You know what? I got it right here.
You got to bring up the Owens Cena thing.
I'm going to exit out.
Yeah.
So, the show opened. It was The Authority. Stephanie McMahon. Made her
first
return
time
to Monday Night Raw. She comes out with Triple H. Stephanie's back. This, that, and the other thing.
She looked good, too.
They talk about payback from the night before. I missed this. You told me about it.
She was wearing a hot little red dress. She looked good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
But they basically talked about payback. Seth Rollins retained the WWE title. Don't get it up.
We were about to go blank.
Okay. But they basically talked about payback. Seth Rollins wound up retaining.
They were putting Rollins over and all that.
Put Rollins over. Yeah. John Cena comes out during the middle of the show.
During the Authority thing?
We're going to a totally different segment.
Okay, yeah.
During the middle of the show, John Cena comes out, cuts that standard promo, you know, U.S. Open. And
well,
I got to tell you something. Let me say
first half was the Rusev payback shit, and then he got into the U.S. Open shit.
But the whole Cena thing, I represent America. Yeah. I'm an American
fighting champion.
It gets old, man.
Well, if it's the same thing,
the same promo every week.
That's the problem.
Yeah.
The only way it's interesting is, well, who's the opponent? Because you don't know. It's a mystery every time. So I think that's why he's getting away with it, and it's not completely shit.
Let me say this.
But, yeah.
It's a mystery every time.
But it's always
an
NXT guy.
Have you noticed?
Yeah.
Sami Zayn 1 week, Neville the next week.
It was the other way around. Neville, Sami Zayn, then Kevin Owens. Like
Neville,
they're going up the ladder.
Right. So Kevin Owens, did you pop?
I popped.
I marked out
a little bit.
Well, listen.
Because if you know his history, and I don't even know the guy that well, but I know enough, like, especially even at the Albany event.
Well, that's what I'm going to say. Tell him what happened at NXT Albany with
Kevin. At the Albany event, he was doing a bunch of Cena shit. Like, he did a five-knuckle shuffle. He
that was
fucking
awesome.
With the crowd.
That was awesome.
And then last night, correct me if I'm wrong.
Last night. On the takeover. Okay.
Didn't he wear the Cena U.S. title t-shirt or whatever with the bell that points
no,
down?
No, he came out with the KO shirt on.
Somebody
last
told
night.
Me he wore the Cena U.S. title t-shirt. I thought it was you.
No.
Alright.
He came out with the KO.
He didn't
KO
put one on at some point?
I don't know if he put... I was gone last night.
You didn't go and watch it on the archive?
I saw the end and he was in the KO shirt.
Okay. Somebody told me he wore the U.S. Cena shirt and I'm like, Jesus, he's still doing it, huh?
But, so Kevin Owens comes out, right? And I thought
he wore
Kevin
the
Owens.
Cena U.S. title shirt. Yeah, Ranjit. I trust Ranjit.
I trust you, Ron. But the clip that I had saw today,
KO with the sleeves
cut
off.
When Samoa Joe came out, he had the KO shirt on.
Maybe he had it on underneath
the end of the segment.
Shirt. Like he came out in the Cena shirt and then took it off. He wore the Cena shirt on. Yeah, he probably took it off. Like he came out.
What about
in the
when
Cena
Samoa
shirt.
Joe came out?
That's
he
what
had
I'm
the
saying. He probably came out in the Cena shirt and underneath was his regular.
Okay.
And he when he did his entrance, he took it off.
He took it off.
The match, and then you're wearing that. I'm guessing.
Okay.
I didn't see
there
it.
There it is.
Yeah.
All right.
Exactly
no doubt. Ron Sheets got it.
Yeah,
all right. Because
yeah.
I watched the clip.
I knew
where
somebody told me that. Yeah.
Samoa Joe came out and he had the
there,
KO
yeah,
shirt
he came
on.
Out and,
okay.
and took it off.
And then took it off. But so I thought Kevin Owens on Raw was awesome. I thought he was great. Basically,
yeah.
Cena was talking about, you know, I'm the current United States champion. And Kevin Owens basically said, listen, or Cena said something along the lines of,
let me give you
some veteran advice. And Kevin Owens responded to
let
that
me stop
by
you
saying,
right there, basically.
By basically
you're
saying, listen, don't give me any veteran advice. I've been in this business for over 15 years. longer than you have. I've been working on the indie scene. I've been around this business longer than you, bro. So don't try to give me any veteran. I thought that line
was great.
Awesome, dude.
But what's good about Cena and where people don't give him enough credit, mm-hmm. like when I think it was Seattle where they were going nuts for Daniel Bryan and he had nothing to do with anything.
Right.
But they had all the wrestlers in the ring, so they're all chanting it and they're trying to sell this Cena Orton as the final match between these two ever. TLC and the year unifying the WWE title versus the world title.
Right.
They're going to unify it, and it's this big thing, and this is the go-home show, the go-home angle, the main event angle, and the whole crowd is Daniel Bryan. Cena is so quick on his feet at improvising.
He's good.
He found a way to incorporate that, give the crowd some tastes of it, and then get it back to where we're trying to go with me and Orton.
Right.
When Owens gave him the don't try and give me veteran advice line, and he went Cena had a quick retort, something to the effect of...
It was good,
Something to the effect of, all right, well, you don't want to fight, let me give you a warning then.
Right,
here's what's going to happen if you fuck with me. Basically is what he's saying, you know, in different words. But that was clever and quick.
Owens wound up laying him out,
right,
and then picked up his title.
He
had the NXT title and the U.S. title.
He stepped on the U.S. title.
Well, he had both titles, right, and then he dropped the U.S. title and stepped on it, and then held up the NXT title, basically saying... I don't want your fucking U.S. title.
Well, he said on
I got the NXT.
On Twitter before the show last night, he had said the reason he did that, he said, I was proving that the belt I have, that's the prize.
Right.
Your belt don't mean shit.
Right.
And that's what I was showing when I did that. Like,
Now, when I said to you, I said, I think they're doing Cena Owens. You said, no, I don't know if Owens is getting called up yet. And I don't know that he is.
He's working a pay-per-view. But
they announced later in the show in a backstage segment where Kevin Owens was with Renee Young or somebody like that and basically said that at the Elimination Chamber pay-per-view I'm taking on John Cena and the United States title is going to be on the line and I'm taking that title too. So
is it for the title?
I believe so.
Okay.
But what I want to ask you is, all right,
Cena defends every time he wrestles.
Does Kevin Owens come up and does he win the U.S. title and stay on the main roster?
No.
Or does he not win the U.S. title and this is just a temporary thing and then he goes back to NXT?
He's
still got the title. Now, they're taping TV tonight, so unless Owens loses...
Drop it to Joe or somebody.
Yeah.
Sorry for the spoiler. We'll get to that in a second. But I didn't say which Joe. It could be Florida Joe, for all you know. But
it could be Joe Gallagher.
I just looked at JR's Barbecue, his blog yesterday. Yeah. I just reread the title today. It said, going to see Joe... .. Welsh tonight, NXT will be the talk of the town tomorrow, Raw thoughts,
Blah, blah, blah.
I was like, wow, he just, like, all day,
right.
All day we're like, well, because we had heard a bunch of names that were backstage.
Right.
And apparently, Samoa Joe was not backstage.
Right.
Or if he was, they
They kept him hidden.
Because Triple H held a meeting immediately after the show last night and pretty much thanked all the roster for not leaking the Joe thing out to the internet.
Right.
Because it never leaked. And even, like, my boss was, like, bummed. Like, man, I'm fucking...
Yeah.
That new Reddit guy that's the new source on Reddit
was,
like, flat out saying, no, he's signed.
He's
he will
coming.
Be at the end of the show on NXT.
You know what...
He's 100% right.
You know what other...
And he predicted the Owens on Raw thing with Cena, too.
He did.
So this guy knows his shit, whoever he is.
You know what other Joe it could have been?
Joe... Blanchard from San Antonio. Who?
Joe Mama! Oh! Boom!
That was good, right?
You didn't like that?
Say it again.
You know what other Joe it could have been?
What?
Joe Mama!
Hold on, how'd you do
that? Ow!
When I did the Joker,
boom!
You didn't laugh. Back at you, bitch. Where we leave off?
I thought that was pretty good.
Yeah.
These nuts. Got him! Got him! Alright, get to our live chat.
No, you'd ask me.
WZRonline.com/chat. WZRonline.com/chat.
You would ask me, does Owens beat Cena for the title at Elimination Chamber? My answer is no, because I don't see him taking that U.S. title off Cena yet. So then my brain starts going, well, how do they get out of that match? Finish that match. Why would they book it? Especially 2 days before Owens is defending his title on their big NXT special.
Nobody
gave a shit about Owens and Zayn, because, hey, half the smart fans knew Zayn was hurt and it wasn't going to be much of a match.
Right.
And the casual fans are more concerned about Owens and Cena.
Yeah. Owens and Samoa Joe is going to be an awesome feud, though.
That's going to be nasty.
That'll be great.
That's why I don't think he's getting called up full-time yet, because they want to do that. Right. First.
Right.
But yeah, so I don't know how they get out of that match at the Chamber. They're not beating Owens in his first main roster pay-per-view anything. His first main roster anything match. He didn't have a match.
You know, well, speaking of the Chamber.
And the Chamber's in a week and a half.
What do you think about that tag team match, dude? I was just saying to you last night, they've got a tag
three people.
They're going to have to be like in the Chamber, like right up against each other, dude. You know that Chamber's
one person from each team would have to start, so it would only be two people in the Chamber, I would think.
Right.
If it's a tag team, there's only one and two.
All right.
The only three-person group's the New Day.
So listen, that was... Shut your mouth.
Jacob, go play!
All right, so NXT TakeOver from last night. I thought that was a great show. Finn Balor opened up the show. He defeated Tyler Breeze.
Yeah, and they got the awesome entrance for the 80th time in Winter Park, Florida.
Well, we had Finn Balor, Tyler Breeze, and Kevin Owens. So we saw Finn Balor and Tyler Breeze last night to open NXT.
Yeah.
Finn Balor wound up winning, so he's the new contender. So, obviously, there's going to be a three-way, right? You would think Samoa Joe, Kevin Owens, and Finn Balor, the three of them.
It depends on what they're doing with Owens.
Yeah.
Maybe they brought Joe in to be the new Owens. And, all right, now that we're moving Owens up, we got Joe here to take his place.
Could be that.
You never know what they're talking. And then, all
right, right,
so now we got Balor in position to take the title. Joe and Balor were...
But then
they did the face-off last night, so obviously they're doing something with Joe and Owens.
Maybe Joe
beats him for the title, and then Owens moves up. Who the fuck knows, man?
I think NXT is...
I really think we're in the middle of a case of them doing that booking-on-the-fly thing where they don't even really know themselves where they're going.
Right, but I think NXT is probably the hottest product
now.
Absolutely.
It's clearly the hottest product.
Absolutely. We had a great time.
Enthusiasm and passion.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
And NXT last night, overall, I mean, every NXT TakeOver special, from top to bottom, dude, from when they started to last night, has been awesome.
Every one of them.
I want to hear from Jackie, so load up the phone lines real quick, and then we're going to start taking rapid fire. We're going to do them in a real rapid fire fashion, because we only got 9 minutes to go. This flew, well, we didn't get until about 19:920, so. The TNA thing ran long, so that's why. Everybody's already seen Raw. Most of you guys saw NXT TakeOver.
Yeah.
So, will you load the phone lines up, which I know you just did.
I don't want to say it on the
air,
but there's no reason we can't go a little long tonight. There's nothing
happening. We can go about 10 minutes now.
Literally nothing
happening. So, I got some stuff.
You're a little behind, but yeah, I'm not.
But anyway, so we're going to load up the phone lines while Boone's doing that right now. I'll start with rapid fire. Anthony Remy, thoughts on Cena versus Owens at the Elimination Chamber? We kind of talked about that. And do you think we will ever get Bully Ray versus Kevin Owens match on NXT? Bully Ray has been teasing that on Twitter
a lot.
But Bully Ray also teased that he was going to be in Philadelphia at the NXT shows.
It makes me think I think he's trying to get a job.
Yeah?
Like, trying to get interest on his own, and then there's so much interest that WWE's like, well, let's bring him in. And,
yes.
You
know. Axelmania is an example of that.
Man, she's quick.
Look at that. She is quick.
Yeah.
She is quick.
This is running like shit right now, but...
All right. Jackie, baby, what's going on?
Nothing much.
We missed you.
What did you think? Get right into it, girl. Rusev, Lana, I know that's what you want to talk about, at least I'm assuming. Correct me if I'm wrong. What are your thoughts? What are you thinking?
I do want to talk about that a little bit.
Oh.
I worry bummed about the I Quit match on Sunday.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, okay. And then I'm watching later. I'm like, okay. Don't yell at her. She didn't want you to get hurt. What do you want to do? Get your neck rebroken?
Listen though. For the last month or two on here, every week we've been telling you they're gonna split up, and you even tweeted me on Twitter and basically said that even after WWE storylines, you know they go home together, and you know they go to Nashville, Tennessee. They just recently bought that house, and I told you on Twitter, I said let's see where they go with Ziggler and Lana, and let's see if they even continue with that, or if that was a Ziggler and Lana kissed on Raw.
Yeah, you said for weeks you've been saying that.
You know, but let's see what happens.
Did it 2 days ago.
Let's see what happens. You know, let's give him a chance. We knew that the Rusev Lana split was coming, and who knows, man? Maybe Lana and Ziggler. Maybe you wind up liking them more than you did Rusev and Lana.
I think it's a coincidence too that management picked the prettiest fucking guy. To put Lana with.
They
love splitting couples up. What is wrong with them?
I know.
Jesus.
I know.
Anyway, I'm sorry.
So anyway, but let's see what happens with Ziggler and Lana. It may turn out to be a good thing, you know?
Okay.
All right. I know, so, you're upset.
I'm like, okay, you know, you're right, let's see what happens.
Let's see what happens. Let's see what happens. Don't sweat it. What else you want to talk about? One more. We got one more. Well, one more question for you.
Well, what's going on with Samoa Joe? A friend of mine saw him last Saturday, and I asked her, I haven't even talked to her about this. Did he mention to you that he was going to be down in Florida for NXT? Because last time I saw Samoa Joe was a year ago when I stopped watching TNA, and I'm like, I hear about what happened because I didn't watch Unstoppable, and I saw a couple pictures on my Instagram, and I'm like, what the hell are you doing there? Are you crazy?
No, he's doing good. He's a main eventer. I mean, he debuted last night at NXT TakeOver. He's at the TV tapings tonight. Somebody just posted a photo on my Facebook page. So,
but his deal is not an exclusive deal with WWE. That's worth mentioning. He's still got a bunch of...
Do he and Owens know each other?
Yes, absolutely.
They used to work down at Ring of Honor. It was Kevin Steen, Kevin Owens, now in WWE. Samoa Joe, it's interesting that they're letting him use
the name and
the
everything.
Samoa Joe ring name. But
like I was trying to say, he doesn't have an exclusive. He's still got indie dates on the books.
Indie dates, too.
They're letting him do them. And as far as I've heard, it's not just, do the ones you've got booked already. He's still allowed to go do indie shit.
Yeah, yeah.
So he's got a special deal. And the name, like you said, yeah.
But
and
Kevin,
he's got merchandise as part of it.
Yeah, Kevin Steen and Samoa Joe had an epic feud down in Ring of Honor.
Did they, or are you just guessing?
No, I'm positive.
Because I can picture Joe leaving Ring of Honor for TNA way before Steen was on the scene.
No, back in
the... He's been around 15 years. I just never heard of him.
Back in the early days of Ring of Honor, you had Daniel Bryan, Samoa Joe... Kevin Steen down there.
El Generico.
Delirious was still
Low
there.
Low Key, maybe.
Low Key was in there. I mean, those
Daniels.
Were... Christopher Daniels. Frankie Kazarian.
Yeah.
You had all those guys
AJ
down
Styles.
In...
AJ Styles.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah.
CM Punk was another guy that was in Ring of Honor. I don't know a little bit Ring of Honor, but I bet you any money AJ Styles is going to be the next ex-TNA guy in the WWE.
You think AJ will come to WWE?
I don't know if AJ's going to come to WWE. I think
they
AJ...
did try just recently when his TNA thing was done, and he ended up... I think he turned WWE down.
He turned them down.
They wanted to do the NXT thing with him, and he's like, no, I'm not going through your developmental system, which I bet he regrets now, because
if you look at NXT,
it's like
a lot of
the place to be, if you're especially an AJ Styles kind of guy.
A lot of people in NXT don't want to be called up to the main roster because
they got too much freedom and too much fun.
NXT is so dope these days. But
I think creatively they don't want to be called up.
Right.
Financially, they're dying to be called up.
Absolutely.
But it's a split.
I think AJ Styles makes enough money in New Japan and Mexico.
Supposedly he's happier than he's ever been.
Where he's happy with the money he's making in Mexico and New Japan. Or anywhere
more fun
in
than ever is what they say.
So anyway, all right, Jackie, you have a good week. All right, and let's see where the Rusev Lana and Ziggler thing goes. All right.
Okay. All right. I'll talk to you guys on Tuesday.
All righty. Have a good week. There's Jackie. Let's take one
Jackie.
More. One more. Baggy tonight.
Tabs over.
Hey, no. Caller, you're live on WPRTV. What's going on?
Yeah. You're talking about if Steve and Joe feuded with each other in ROH. They are feuded with each other in ROH.
Nobody's.
Are you sure?
No,
no,
I said Cena and Joe.
Yeah, Joe was nearly well out.
Wait a minute.
He said Cena. No,
said Steen and
that's
Joe.
That's what I thought. Steen wasn't
even
on the scene when Joe left.
What about
the
days?
Hold on. Say that again. What was that last part?
I think they may have been PWG, but I'm not sure.
I think they've touched heads before, heads before, but I don't think they had a big ROH thing.
Pro Wrestling Guerrilla,
yeah. I think
about.
Joe was already gone from ROH to TNA, and they wouldn't let him do ROH anymore.
I
and
thought,
then Steen was like the next guy after him.
I'm 99% sure that you're probably right, but I thought like Samoa Joe, Kevin Steen, CM Punk, AJ Styles, all those guys. I thought they were all there at the same time.
I thought Steen was the
and
next
Joe
class.
And Steen.
Like the freshman
no,
of the
Steen came season. In around 2006, 2007-ish.
Okay.
After Punk was out.
That's what I thought.
And
all
Joe
right.
Was
I don't even follow it.
Joe
so.
Started working Ring of Honor more.
All right. I'll take your word. That's my bad, man. That's my bad. I appreciate the heads up, though.
But.
All right. Have a good night, man.
All right.
Yeah, the chat's confirmed, and it was like one match in 2005 in Pro Wrestling Guerrilla. So.
All right, that's my bad. I thought that Steen and Samoa Joe had a feud down in ROH.
I couldn't say otherwise because I don't follow the scene enough, but I just remember not Steen, when he got over, like, he was over.
All right.
So, but that seemed like it wasn't 15
Rygar
years ago.
Says, you know, Steen was the next class after those guys.
Yeah, like all right. the CM Punk, Daniel Bryan, all those guys were like seniors, and those were the little freshmen that were just trying
By
the time the seniors graduated, then they took the
class.
So it
was like Samoa Joe, CM Punk, AJ Styles, and then
Christopher Daniels.
After them,
yeah, and then after them was
Sami Zayn,
Kevin Owens.
Okay.
All right. Okay. Yeah. All right.
You guys are right. My bad. All right. Let's get some rapid fire quick. I love the callers. I love the chat room. Because if we're ever wrong,
it's like an instant.
Boom!
It's an instant
right
Google
there.
Without searching. Like,
yeah.
You say something, they're like, no, actually it was 2004. Like, oh,
they're
shit,
good.
Sorry, 2004.
They're good.
Yeah.
All right, no doubt. All right, so we took Anthony Remy.
Matt Johnson says, I read a new report saying TNA has told its talent they will address the recent rumors at the next set of tapings. The tapings are a little over a month away. I find it strange they're keeping their own talent in the dark for a month. Thoughts.
That's probably part of the reason why they sent out that statement today that says it's
keep
completely,
yeah.
completely false, and we'll address it at the TV tapings. But for right now, we're telling you guys it's false. And
it's basically what you get worried about is the whole roster finds out. It's like in a basketball game when you're down by like 12 points and there's only 8 seconds left. You're never supposed to stop trying, but
right.
You know damn well when that situation comes, you're not trying anymore.
Absolutely.
You know it's a foregone conclusion, it's over.
Right.
They don't want their talent to be like half-assing it right now, because now, in their minds, well, if we go to Wednesday and we can get these numbers up, we'll mm-hmm. be stay, so we need you to work harder than ever. So we
Absolutely.
Don't want you thinking it's over and like just calling it in and
right.
phoning
right.
it
right.
in every night.
Phoning
we want
it.
You to go fucking nuts
right.
for us.
Right.
So they got to try and damn near lie to them and keep their morale high.
John Morgan, any chance of getting Sonny to call in for an exclusive WZR TV statement on air?
Chat. We can work on that for next week.
We can do that next week if she's not mad at me.
That's
she's
true.
Not happy with me.
Yeah, she didn't even know me.
Somebody
so I can't do anything.
Somebody went and told her on Twitter that I was talking a bunch of shit, and she said I thought we were cool, and I said we are.
Where do you talk this supposed shit, by the way? Like, this is the show we do. This is where you talk.
No,
I've never heard you say a word. I'd call you on it right now. You know me.
That's what I said. I said, who told you that? I don't know what they're talking about. But, James.
Oh, it's ticking out. That girl's pretty hot. At least from here up.
Huh?
James Layman. Have they decided to press the pause button on Reigns and replace him with Ambrose? They have not decided that, but there's a lot of people that think that's what's going to eventually happen. The big comparison I keep hearing, sorry, real quick, was it's 1995, you'll correct me in the chat on the ear, in that area, Diesel Shawn Michaels. They're trying to go with Diesel because he's bigger, and they're going through the steroid trial, and he's like a naturally big guy, so it's
right.
like, oh, we can get
right.
a new big guy without worrying about him failing a drug steroid test. And then they tried so hard, but they say Kevin Diesel was the worst drawing champion in WWE history.
That's what they say, right?
And that's why they went with Shawn instead. And this is like the same thing, because Reigns is the big guy that has the look, just like Diesel. So let's try him way before he's ready, just like Diesel. Whereas Ambrose, a veteran, just like Shawn Michaels, actually has the goods to carry the ball if we give it to
Seems
him.
Seems like I said it earlier, Ambrose is really... Every week, man, more and more with Ambrose. Joseph Gallo.
They're keeping him strong in case they want to do that.
Right.
I think.
Joseph Gallo, are you surprised that Samoa Joe is keeping his name? And are we going to have a Kevin Owens and Samoa Joe feud for the NXT title soon?
Yes,
very,
yes.
Very surprised. And yes, you are going to see a feud.
Where are we?
Jason Hansen.
Oh, picks for Cormier. Daniel Cormier, Rumble Johnson, Chris Weidman, Vitor Belfort, Travis Brown, Andre Arlovsky. Is Brown Arlovsky part of the show this weekend?
I don't know.
He probably wouldn't have mixed it in there if it wasn't. Click that reply. What is that? And also, Ryan and Matt's thoughts on the overall UFC 187 card. So it is. Wow.
Right.
I knew they had the two. I didn't know they had the third one.
Beckham.
Picks. I'll go Cormier over Rumble.
I got Cormier.
Weidman over Belfort.
I got Belfort.
Really?
Oh.
Wow. Weidman's never been beat.
I like Belfort as of late, though. I like Belfort.
He is a beast.
I like
but
Belfort
he was on
as
he,
of late.
He was on a...
That's true. He's not
TRT.
He was on testosterone
replacement therapy, which was legal when he was doing it. Now it's not. So he had to cycle off. So he's going to be a whole different guy. And he's older.
Yeah, you're right. I'm going to go... man.
But Belfort could do it.
I'm going to go...
I don't think he will, but he could.
Just because I like him... I'm going to go Andre Arlovski.
I got to go Travis Brown.
Are you? Yeah.
Arlovski's looked, since coming back to the UFC, everybody thought he was done.
Yeah.
And then he knocked out, what was it, Bigfoot?
Yeah.
And he beat another guy. Like, so he's looking great right now. But I think he beat maybe Brendan Schaub in like a boring fight. But I think Travis Brown trashes him.
All right. No doubt. Mike Butler with Kevin Owens wrestling Cena on Elimination Chamber. Will he now be on the main roster after this, or will Samoa Joe cost him the match to help start a feud with him?
I wasn't listening.
I think Owens and Samoa Joe are going to do something down in NXT. I don't think Owens is being called up to the main roster full-time just yet, I love the fact that they're taking NXT guys and having them go against John Cena.
I don't.
What better guy on the main roster to put over NXT talents than the top dog in WWE.
He beat them all.
Yeah, but he had a 20-minute match or 15-20-minute match with Neville. Same thing with Zayn.
He gave him
10 minutes.
The only guy he's put over in a sense because he let Owens play him out.
I don't know that he's jobbing him out, dude. If he was jobbing, it'd be like a 1-minute squash match and Cena kills him.
He's not jobbing him out. Putting him over would be trying to put him over.
I guess.
They're bringing him up to get beat and then send him back down. I don't think that's a smart move. They did it with Charlotte and
Natalya. Neville hasn't been sent back down, and Sami Zayn got injured.
Neville got called up before he did the Cena thing. It wasn't like that was his debut. Sami Zayn's was, and then I got yelled at from my boss because it wasn't his debut. He had worked Raw like 4 years ago.
Even if they go back down, the fact that they still worked against John Cena on Monday Night Raw in a good 10 or 15 minute
match. I get what you're saying.
Puts him over, man.
You get the rub with the big guy, and as long as you're competitive, you look on his level.
Yeah.
But then if you take him straight from that and put him right back down in developmental, people aren't remembering that when you bring him back up a year from now. Like, that's not something people are so remembering.
There's only been three NXT guys. It's been Neville, who's on the main roster. Sami Zayn got hurt, so we don't know much about him.
Yeah.
Whether it was going to be a full-time gig. And then Kevin Owens, so there hasn't been that many, so it's not like, you know, we've only had three of them.
I'm just commenting on what you said, where you like the idea of bringing an NXT guy up, have him lose to Cena, and then go back to NXT.
True.
I like the idea of rubbing shoulders with Cena. That's where I agree with you. But not if you're going to get beat and then go back to NXT and not come back for like 8 months or something.
True.
Name the difference between that and Charlotte working with Natalya, the top diva.
Well, that's true.
And then going right back.
That was ridiculous.
That was stupid.
We know that was ridiculous.
And that was to promote the NXT special.
I have no disagreement whatsoever with you on that. All right, Joseph Gallo.
He says, "Are you and Boone? This is for you. Are you and Boone going to any of the ROH shows in New York City, June 19th and 20th?"
As of now, no. We don't have.
I didn't even know they had shows.
Jay Mullen, how awesome was the NXT special last night? It was awesome, bro.
It was awesome.
I didn't see it. Speaking of awesome, Balor's entrance was out of this world.
I did see that.
Made you watch that.
Yeah.
Imagine that on WrestleMania.
Oh, fuck.
For my question, with Joe possibly feuding with Owens, do you guys think Joe cost Owens his match with Cena? Somebody just asked that at Elimination Chamber. It's a good point. We'll see if Samoa Joe comes out, cost Owens his match against John Cena at Elimination Chamber, and then take the Joe Owens feud back down to NXT.
Can I tell you something?
For the title.
Just a minute ago, you said you think Owens beats Cena and wins the title at the Chamber.
I didn't say that.
No, you asked me, do I think? Yeah. And I was like, well, no, I don't see Cena losing the title, but I don't know how they get out of that match. That's how they get out of that match.
There you go. Have Samoa Joe come down.
And then take that
feud back down to NXT.
Correct.
But keep in mind, after last night, Finn Balor is also in there as he's the number one contender for the NXT title.
Yeah.
So you've got to throw Balor in there somewhere.
And you
got to
think, if he's the number one contender, the next special is when he gets his shot. And if they're going to do Joe and Owens,
three-way.
And if they're going to do Joe and Owens, especially set it up at a WWE pay-per-view, you know that's the main event for the title for
Absolutely.
The next special.
Right.
But so what? Is Balor number one contender for six months? Because they only do them every 3 months. Which is why I think they turn into a triple threat.
You've got 4 weeks of TV being taped tonight.
Yeah.
We'll know much more after those tapings tonight.
I don't think we'll know a lot more. Not about this issue. Because this is about the special, which is like three months from now, and the chamber, too.
And the chamber, too.
So it's hard to rate that off of the TV they taped tonight for NXT.
David Hadley,
I just read the last one. Why are there always people seeming celebrating?
I read the last one, didn't I? Did I not?
Oh, you did. You did.
All right.
Why are there always people seeming celebrating? I don't know what that means. Seeming to celebrate the possibility of TNA going out of business.
I agree with you, man. I said it earlier. It's competition.
Are people celebrating that they're going out of business?
Well, it's, you see the comment section, and people are like, ah, ha, ha, I told you so. Ah, TNA's done.
Well, that's ignorant douchebag. You're going to get that no matter what you post.
But you want competition.
Not only competition, but like I said earlier, you want a place for these guys to work.
Nobody should wish that TNA goes out of business.
You're basically wishing.
Like, Moon, like
that
said,
families
you're basically
are going
wishing
out of business. Yeah.
That guys that
with
depend
kids,
on this money
yeah.
that have families are going to lose paychecks. And not only that, but wrestling as a whole, when you lose a promotion,
yeah.
it's less competition and it's less to
and
watch.
It's a lot less jobs. Because not only the wrestlers, but the creative people,
yeah.
the camera people, whatever. And like you said with the kids thing, like I didn't even know Kevin Owens had a kid until I saw the clip of him. Did you see this clip where
it was awesome.
He's reacting to Cena's dad work
with
Cena? And obviously he's the age where he's probably a Cena mark.
I know. Because
he grew up with a wrestling father, so he's obviously a wrestling fan.
Somebody said, boy, man, Kevin Owens' poor son, and his name's Owen, by the way. Owens. But
that's a joke.
Owen Owens. Yeah. But his poor son is going to have to watch his father get jobbed out to John Cena, who is probably his favorite wrestler.
It's like Jake.
So my dad is going to get jobbed out to my favorite wrestler. Who do I pick? My favorite wrestler or my dad?
Yeah, who are you rooting for in that one? I've never had a dad, right. So I don't know. But
well,
I would assume you have to root for your dad, even if you love John Cena. You got to be like, kick his ass, dad.
Right?
I don't know.
All right, we got a couple more here. Vincent Nugent, I think you guys should get one of the TNA representatives on the WZR TV for an interview. I didn't talk to anybody in management today. I talked
no,
to it's
wrestlers.
Like you said earlier. For an interview about the latest happenings and what's going on with Impact, what do you guys think about that? Talked about that earlier, man.
I mean, we could try, but I don't think we'd get anywhere with that. They don't want to talk about this.
I could try Bob Ryder, but he's not big
on
me.
If he knows my name, at least.
He's not coming on
if
here.
He hears my name, he ain't coming. He used to talk so much shit about me back
I know he did.
Nathaniel Lippincott.
Puff Bagwell. No,
yeah, it was me and Fred Cook was the other reporter.
Yeah,
he would call us, what was it, Coon and Crook.
Yeah.
Instead of Boone and Cook.
Yep.
He didn't want to use our real names. He thought we would sue him. I could sue anybody. I don't give a shit. You could say Matt Boone's a dickhead. I could give two shits. Nathaniel Lippincott has two of them here, and he says, with recent events with TNA, could we see WWE buying them out and doing a repeat of the invasion angle? No. They don't even consider them anything worth buying. No. His second one, by the way, great job, guys. Always enjoy the show. Thank you.
You the man, bro. Lance Winter, now that no curb stomp for Rollins, it's not banned officially. I mean, there's going to be random times where he may do it.
It's banned.
It's banned permanently.
They don't.
We're never going to see the curb stomp again.
Maybe it's just a name. Maybe he has to rename it.
We are never going to see the curb stomp.
The move?
Yeah.
I don't know. But we're never going to hear it be called the curb stomp.
I think it's going to be special occasions like the Undertaker's tombstone.
He might, when the pile driver was outlawed, and the powerbomb, but they might have to rename, I think the curb stomp is the issue, I think they don't like the name.
The curb stomp,
It sounds,
wasn't that
it's the American History X.
American History
Put
X,
your
right.
fucking mouth
right.
on the curb.
Right. David Hadley, is Elimination Chamber going to be a 3-hour show? It is, man, they're going to do a full pay-per-view, man, from top to bottom. A traditional pay-per-view where it'll be a 2-hour special like NXT. No, it's a 7-8 card show, man.
No, not King of the Ring 1-hour brief Netflix special.
No.
This is a full-on pay-per-view.
This is a full pay-per-view. And when did WWE make the decision to have it? We talked about that week/day due to Daniel Bryan's announcement, or were there plans? They made it very late notice, correct?
Yeah, they canceled that concept and replaced it with Fastlane this year.
Right.
That's where Chamber
right.
used to air. And I guess, I think when they did, my guess, and I'm just guessing, when they did the King of the Ring thing, I think they thought, well, we should do this more often, like find an excuse at a SmackDown taping where we're already there
to
record some shit for the network. Now, they're not doing that here. They're doing a special show just for, like, they're not doing a SmackDown taping and then they're taping the Chamber pay-per-view afterwards. They're doing
this is a whole
one night, only the Chamber pay-per-view. That's the only thing they're doing in the arena and they're going to put it on the network. So, yeah, I just think the idea spawned off of, well, we just did this great special King of the Ring. Like, why don't we,
let's do more of these, Vincent, up next.
Vincent Nugent, did you guys watch the latest episode of Impact Wrestling from this past Friday, themed Hardcore War?
I didn't see it, man.
He says, I thought it was a pretty good show. The wrestling product, not the business side, has been doing well as of late these past several weeks, personally, is what he says. And you said the same thing. You said the product's been good.
I said that I had watched the last 3 weeks of Impact, but I guess I didn't see last Friday's.
So no, he's saying the business side sucks, but he said the product's been great.
Absolutely.
That's what he said.
Right, right. Yeah, a lot of people saying the same thing. Yeah. David Hadley, Ryan, did you check out any of the ROH New Japan Pro Wrestling shows from last week? I have not yet. I'd like to see those. I know they are on VOD, Video On Demand, on ROHWrestling.com, so I may purchase those and check them out.
Vincent Nugent said, did you guys watch the HBO boxing event from this past
week? Did you guys watch?
Every
time.
I correct it without reading it.
I know. But he does it every time. Did you guys watch?
Yeah. The only time I read their mistakes is when I don't understand what they're even trying to say.
I know.
I don't want to sound stupid.
Watch.
Yeah, did you guys watch the HBO boxing event from this past Saturday night featuring the fight between Gennady Golovkin and Willie Monroe Jr.?
I didn't know that was on.
Is Gennady Golovkin the real deal, you think? I told you about this. Triple G, and they think Mayweather's ducking him.
Oh, he's the guy that can beat Mayweather.
He knocked
about.
This dude out, this Willie Monroe, in like 3 rounds, but from what Dan was telling... Dan, is that his name?
Yeah.
Why is it Dave? Dan was telling... Yeah, I'm retarded. God, my memory's off. I was just hanging out with him the other day. He says that that Gennady Golovkin, he was like getting his ass kicked a little bit in the fight, and it only lasted a few rounds, and then he knocked Monroe out. But
okay,
so I've never even heard of this Monroe, and if he can give him fucking trouble, I don't think he's beating Mayweather. But I don't know enough about Triple G to say anything.
Right.
So, but I didn't watch the show. No.
All right, we'll try to get to a couple of new people here.
Yeah, there's a lot of new names,
guys. Ryan Hollywood, God of Rock, Huckabee.
Whew. Where was this taken? I don't remember Joe wearing the shorts and taking his shirt off.
That's what I was. That's
okay.
The last
I remember saying that.
So Ryan Hollywood, God of Rock, Huckabee.
Whew. I would have said Godfrock. I would have read that wrong. I'm glad
this
you got
the first
that.
Time I'm seeing the Mega Powers with Hogan and
Savage. Yeah.
Seriously, here this is a disgrace to three legends: Randy Savage, Hulk Hogan, and Kurt Hennig. Vince
should be ashamed.
Why is it
a disgrace to Kurt Hennig? Just because it's his son? Like, they're not saying anything about Mr. Perfect.
How
are they disrespecting Mr. Perfect? Just because they're making his son do something stupid?
I think Mr. Perfect, just knowing the fact that his son is on Raw every week, he'd be proud, man. He'd be proud just knowing that...
Absolutely.
That...
especially the way the business is these days. If you're able to get a job on the main roster in WWE, that you're good.
Vincent
Nugent.
At least
they think you're good.
It's for me, so I'll take it.
I do got to say real quick before you do... I know we're rushing.
No, we're fine.
The Jerry Lawler documentary came out this week.
Did you watch it?
I downloaded it. I watched it.
Good.
I highly recommend it.
Really?
It was so good.
Really?
It was so good.
Wow.
It was great.
Vince Nugent.
They covered the Andy Kaufman thing so good.
Did they?
Yeah. And I've heard that story a million times. They covered it great.
Let me see. Andy Kaufman is not alive, correct?
No, he's dead.
He's dead.
Okay. He's been dead.
Okay.
All right.
They
had that famous thing on the Letterman show, which they showed last night.
With Lawler and Kaufman, right?
Yeah, they showed Lawler slapping Kaufman last night on his last show.
Why don't...
It was one of the most famous nights in the history of TV.
This is going to sound so stupid, and I'm sorry for even asking you people in the chat.
Yeah.
Who was Andy Kaufman?
He was a... It's hard to explain. He was
a movie star?
He was a comedian that wasn't a comedian. Like, he would do what they call experimental comedy.
Right.
He would go up on stage and pretend to be a foreign guy that could barely speak broken English, and then he would, like, turn around and say, I want to do my impression of, and then he would do, like, a guy's impression, and then just say their famous line in his same voice. Like let's say Arnold Schwarzenegger, which he didn't do, but let's just say... Cause
I'll be back.
He would say... I want to do my Arnold Schwarzenegger impression. I'll be back. And he would still say it in the same voice. And he would do like 3 or 4 impressions like that in a row where he's not impersonating anyone. He's just saying their lines in his same voice. And then he would say, now I want to do the Elvis Presley. And then he would turn around and he would fucking comb his hair and he would change his clothes.
I'm all shook up.
And he'd come back. And he would look just like Elvis. And he would fucking go, well, it won't hold the money. It won't hold the show. You get ready. He did it perfectly.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
And he had this guy, Tony Clips. Like, he was a pro wrestler that wasn't in pro wrestling. He wouldn't do stand-up. He would do all these weird things. He would try and piss the crowd off, not make them laugh.
Right.
He was amazing.
Yeah.
I'm my hero.
Yeah.
Jim Carrey did his life story, Man on the Moon. Like, he was a very unique
some of that
dude.
Stuff on YouTube?
Oh, all of it. Sure. I was watching a bunch of it the other day.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
It's so funny, man.
All right.
Fucking funny, yeah.
Vincent Nugent, Ryan, there is no more TNA Wrestling's Greatest Matches television show from Destination America as well. Yeah, man. They took off Unlocked. They took off the Greatest Matches.
What the fuck is Unlocked, anyway? I've heard of it. Explosion.
It's like a Saturday morning type show that they do. I'll take the last one here, man. David Hadley, actually, no, Destination America isn't very small. It's part of Discovery Communications, publicly traded. Listen, dude.
Yeah, Discovery Communications is big. Destination America is their little pet project.
Discovery Channel is a pretty big network. I'll give you that. But Destination America is like a
subsidiary
of that, and it's on the very low end.
And now, it's new, and they're trying to grow it.
They're in a lot of homes. Destination America.
They got good clearance.
But
out of 300 channels, everybody's got good clearance.
What we were doing earlier is comparing Spike TV versus Destination
Spike
America.
Spike TV, basic cable, man. You can turn your fucking Spike TV on.
You're right.
You need a cable box and a special premium package to watch Destination America. You got to go out of your way to watch it, you know. Yes, sir.
Give it up, brother.
By the way, they're saying how cool the Foo Fighters and Everlong. I thought that was great last night. Where they played the song live and they would show all the clips. And that was where the Kaufman Law thing was shown.
David Letterman's final show was last night.
Awesome.
And I guess we'll end it with a classic line. The line that David Letterman
ended
every show.
I want to see what this is before.
Were they wrong?
It says, wrong, Boone. I got the very basic of cable, and I don't get Spike. No, sure you do.
You get Spike if
on
you get
basic
the
cable.
Basic cable. You
now,
can
he's
get
probably
Spike.
Talking about, like, with no cable. I'm talking about cable TV, not network TV.
Right.
Network TV, you get NBC, ABC, CBS, Fox, and
maybe another channel or two. Like six channels
or
something like that.
I'm talking if you've got cable without a cable box.
If you've got basic cable, you get
Spike's
Spike TV, USA
Absolutely.
Network,
MTV,
ESPN.
VH1. Those are all
that stuff.
Yeah.
That's Tuesday, brother.
He might be
Thursday.
He might be like from England or something. Who knows?
Yeah, it could be something like that. All right. Thanks to everybody that came out tonight on a special Thursday night show. We promised you. We apologize for the issues. It wasn't on our end.
We came on here
for about 20 minutes on Tuesday night. I know some of you guys tuned out, but we were here on Tuesday night for about 20 minutes. Did a very brief rundown of, you know, NXT and whatever else. But we promised you guys that we were going to be back here on Thursday night this week, and that's what we wound up doing.
He wants to be acknowledged here, I think. So he's saying, no, I have a box from Comcast. He lives in DeKalb, Illinois, whatever the fuck that city's called. I've never heard of it. I don't know why you wouldn't get Spike TV. That's a regular cable channel.
That's weird.
Yeah.
Comcast? You got Comcast, too?
I had Comcast in Florida. I had it. But I had the box and everything.
So. But, anyways, so we will see all of you guys next Tuesday night, 8 to 10 Eastern time. I know some of you guys tuned in for the Impact News tonight. Hopefully we're able to bring that to you and run it down so that you guys can understand it. We're going to have more on that story on the website. The article is going to go up either late tonight or tomorrow. If it's not tonight, it'll definitely be tomorrow.
One more line with this guy, and his name is Slayery from the chat. We were mentioning him earlier.
He got you all wound up here.
I think he's one of the guys we met. No, I just don't want to sit here and be like telling him, like, you're wrong, we're right. I believe you. He's saying, I don't, though. I don't get it. I got the box. I live in Illinois. I don't get spiked. I believe you. Yeah. I'm just saying you should get spiked. I don't know why you don't. So.
That's weird. If you got basic cable, you should get that.
You should get that, yeah.
Call your cable company and see what's up,
You shouldn't even need a box. No, you should just be able to... If your TV's cable ready and you program it and let it run through the channels and find each one that it can get...
Right.
It should get the... Not just the Fox, ABC, NBC. It should get the ESPN, the MTV, all those.
All right, we are out of here. We will see you guys next Tuesday night, 8 to 10 Eastern time. We want your feedback.
How do they do it?
Can they submit?
Oh, you want me to tell them?
I want you to tell, just like you did Rapid Fire.
I guess I'll tell them
how to submit feedback.
Pretty simple. You go to facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. Let them know what you liked. Let them know what you didn't like. If you tell them something you like, they'll do more of it. If you tell them something you didn't like, they'll do less of it. That's how you tell them what you thought of the show. Tell me what you thought of the show by going to facebook.com/MattBooneWZR. That's facebook.com/MattBooneWZR. Let me know.
Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. We are out of here. In the words
of
a legend by the name
of
David Letterman. Thank you.
And have a good night.
And good night.
Yeah. You got a pencil to throw behind you?
Good night, Joe. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Hey, come here. Show them, bud. Hi, wrestlers. Who's this guy?
Punk.
That's CM Punk?
Yeah.
All right. Who's this guy?
Oh.
Who's that one?
Oh. What is it? What is that?
That's, Ray.
What?
Ray?
Ray.
Ray who?
Ray.
Ray Mysterio? Ray Mysterio?
Oh!
Show him the title belt.
Are you still on it?
We're on. We're live. We're not live. We're doing a close show here.
Don't put it on.
What? Who's that? Will you get out of here? You're annoying us. This is Allison. Say hello. Come on. Now come back.
No, I was told to get out of here.
Who's this guy?
What is that?
Sin Cara.
Sin Cara?
That one's Sin Cara. We bought him all these, toys today. So we got, Sin Cara up here. He's showing off his, figures.
Who's this guy?
Who is it? That's Johnny Boy.
You gotta hold it like this.
That's
no
John. Oh, we're all going down here.
Let me see the six.
Look at. We'll take
Sin Cara
and Red.
I don't know. This is CM Punk.
All right. And then we got John here. We got John. Uh oh.
Smoke one of yours. You don't have any mine.
We got John. And then who's this?
CM Punk.
This is CM Punk.
Yeah.
All right. We'll put CM Punk up here.
I warned him.
Who's the champion? Uh-oh. We got them all here. And then...
fucking rid of this man on here, man. You got
ready? Champ is here! Champ! Lift it up. Champ is here!
There's a champion!
Alright. We gotta take down the set.